As much as we thought the stuff that was in the crate, we got a map to our spot. We got two pots and a pen, two machetes, and a small knife and then a magnifying glass. Robst and starting a fire became an exercise.
I'm a natural woman. A vaggie natural woman. And that's why the very first sign of itching, I reach for Femcream.
Hey, I don't have time for yeast infection. That's why I go with Gynalubamide.
Doctors,
whoa, we gotta get some of that.
Yeah, we don't have time for a yeast infection either.
Holy crap! Whoa! What the hell is this crap?
Oh my gosh!
Is this like a joke?
Yeah.
I think it's safe to say that this sucks.
Yeah, it sucks.
I thought people usually look cool in leather jackets.
Yeah. What's wrong? I don't need you to all look like Woody.
Sometimes it just doesn't work, Beavis.
It isn't like vinyl jackets.
No, they're leather. You can't polish a turd, Beavis.
Yeah, I tried that once. I got like some dog doo-doo and like some black shoe polish. Trying to polish it, but it's like you can't polish a turd.
That's disgusting, Beavis.
Yeah.
I bet it was pretty cool to try, though.
That caught you, kid.
Yeah. Focus.
Don't think cool kid.
He just supposed to be cool kid.
Yeah.
I'd hate to see the uncool kid.
Yeah.
Whoa. It's Barbie.
Yeah. Gotta get some dude without a wiener to play Ken.
Why don't you go for it, Beavis?
Shut up, butthead.
This chick has more teeth than most people.
Yeah. Bite me.
She looks like that chick in the mall.
Chicken what?
That chick in the mall.
That chicken? What do you mean?
No, asswipe. I'm talking about that chick.
Oh, you mean that chick that worked that chick fillet? That chicken plate?
What's your problem, Beavis? I'm not talking about chicken. Pull your thumb out of your ear and put it back in your butt.
Shut up, butthead. You didn't talk about chicken. You said that chicken mall.
I said that chick in the mall. This video is upbeat.
It makes me want to get up and beat it.
You said up. This makes me feel good.
This video?
No, this.
This Saturday, sunset to sunrise, bang your head till your ears bleed at the Civic Amphitheater. It's Slayer,
Metallica,
Megadeth,
and Color Me Bad.
It's a lot of metal. It's mucho metal.
Whoa. Hey, Beavis, your nose is bleeding.
Cool. We're there, dude. Got any money?
45 cents. How about you?
I spent all my money playing Zeltar. Got something we can sell?
Sperm?
Yeah.
Alright, good talk, bots, laughs, electrical whooshing, oh, beeping and whirring, no, high-pitched whirring, smiler, don't let him escape, high five, party time, wait a minute, lively chatter, high five inhales and exhales deeply, the air is better here, laughs, beer, tea, I'm coffee, sorry, cheese, so edgy, Latin music playing, high five gasps, exhales heavily, oh, my old cube, runs, take a hike, Mike, my name's not Mike, screams, what, there's AV bots coming, for me, just because I'm in the wrong section, all gasping, electrical whooshing, holy delito, emojis clamoring, whoa, panting, gasps, hands, what do we do, quick, this way, let's go, don't tell anyone you're about to see this, they'll never find us down here, Gene, where are we, the basement, no, welcome to the loser lounge. Where the emojis who never get used hang out. Squares never fit in a circle of friends. Go fish cake with swirl. Laughs, laughs. Room, sweep so you won't cry. Sweep so you won't cry. Sobs, sweep so you won't cry. I almost got deleted. Me, high five. Hey, what's up, high five? They weren't trying to delete you. They were trying to delete me. You, what's so important about you? They send out an entire team of bots. They say I'm a malfunction. All gas, music stops, video game beeps. Oh, you bringing malfunctions in here now. High five. Or crying out loud. Abandoned luggage. That had better not be my leftover Chinese food. What Chinese food? Hiccups, laughs, sighs. Do you have est of them just cuss us out and drive off? And the few that stay are mad as heck because they're eating off paper. And they gotta discard their own trash. Why, you're doing great, Mac. Yeah, we won't be coming out to the car, but you can come on up. Welcome to McDonald's, Dick. We may have underestimated the learning curve, so by 5 o'clock Dick is calculating how much it's going to cost to go back to drive-in, but I am not ready to throw in the towel. I go back to our old Hollywood days. I think to myself, we gotta go big with this. We gotta put on a show. So I say, Dick, I wanna throw a grand reopening, a gala premiere that would put Louis B. Meyer to shame. So we rent a bunch of spotlights, same ones we used to haul around in the Columbia days. We get sparklers, a juggler for the kiddies. It is an event. People show up in droves, and then, Dick, the flies. They must have been drawn by all the lights. Mac, millions of them. It was was like a scene out of Exodus. The Pharaoh would have released the Israelites. Rock music, Mac, total disaster. Now it is towel time. The next day, Dick and I meet up to discuss going back to the old format. And as we're talking, there's a knock at the service window. I tell him we're closed, but he looks so cute. Hang on, what would you like, son? Can I buy a bag of burgers from you? 3. Yes, please, Mac. And I feel bad, so I fire up the grill and I make him a batch. There you are. As he's walking away from the service window, a car pulls up, and then another. Dick, and then another. Hello, welcome to McDonald's, man. Hello there, Mac. Pretty soon there's a line around the block. The word has spread, and it's off to the races, Mac. And we are an overnight sensation. 30 years in the making. So that's our story. Hence of music franchise. Beg your pardon, franchise. Franchise the damn thing. It's too damn good for just one location. There should be McDonald's everywhere, coast to coast, sea to shining sea. Mr. Croc, hey, you know what? I got a confession I want to make to you, boys. I'm not out here in California or any kind of business meetings. I came out here for you. A few days ago, I got into St. Louis, Missouri, and I was doing some business, and I broke out my map, and I followed my finger on one single highway west, Route 66. Mr. Croc, and something told me to get into my car and drive that highway. 50 pounds, you said? 750 pounds, it is. What is your name? Vasily Palvos, sir. Yeah, we're gonna change that name. I think you're Irish. We have a show. That's good, but I need it 5 times bigger, and I want it everywhere. Carriages, sides of trains, trolleys, crates, milk bottles, everywhere they look. Arnhem's American Museum. Man, nice to see you, sir. You stumble through your days, got your head hung low. Your sky's a shade of gray, like a zombie in a maze. Too, please, you're asleep inside, but you can shake awake, cause you're just a dead man walking. Thinking that's your only option, but you can flick the switch, and brighten up your darkest day. Sun is up and the colors blinding. Take the world and redefine it. Leave behind your narrow mind, you'll never be the same. Come alive, come alive. Go and light your light, let it burn so bright. Reaching up to the sky, and it's open wide. You're electrified, and the world becomes a fantasy, and you're more than you could ever be. Cause you're dreaming with your eyes wide open, whoa. And you know you can't go back again, to the world that you were living in. Cause you're dreaming with your eyes wide open, so come alive, whoa. People gasping, letting, they're waiting, or what, for you? No, they don't know it yet, but they are gonna love you. Trust me, people gasp. Tom, up, I see it in your eyes. You believe that lie, that you need to hide your face, afraid to step outside, so you lock the door. But don't you stay that way, no more living in those shadows. You and me, we know how that goes. Cause once you see it, oh, you'll never be the same. A little bit of lightning striking, bottled up to keep on shining. You can prove there's more to you, you cannot be afraid. Come alive, go and light your light, let it burn so bright. Reaching up to the sky, and it's open wide. You're electrified, and the world becomes a fantasy, and you're more than you could ever be. Cause you're dreaming with your eyes wide open, and we know we can't go back again to the world that we were living in. Cause we're dreaming with our eyes wide eats. Those are claws. Okay, Michael, want you to take a minute to think of what that cleanup might be. I don't have the time for your insane shit. Okay, at that point, you sell the car. I never used you. The depreciation. I just left you because you couldn't forgive me for something I didn't even do. Transport is in there. Is that blood? Dude, what the fuck? Both grunting. Groans. Amelia gasps. You know how long I've been waiting for this? Grunts. Oh, no, I'm not gonna load, motherfucker. Both grunting. Hey, whoa. Let's talk about this. Okay, even a dumbass like you is smart enough to keep one in the pie. Oh, shit. And 99. Darius Kincaid. Jesus Christ. Michael, this is who you want me to protect? My shirt. Shouting in French. Fine. You get the feet, I'll get the nostrils. Reporter on radio. The trial of former Belarusian president Vladislav Dukhovich took an uncertain turn this week, having recently survived a dioxin poisoning attempt that left his face disfigured. Authorities are keeping Dukhovich. Interpol wishes to have a word. Quite the dust up in Coventry this morning, but you wouldn't know anything about that, would you? Turns radio off. You've come here to lodge a complaint. I've come for my money. I delivered as promised. I gave you Kincaid as exposed as you'll ever get him. Small security detail. Practically a rookie leading them. I can't do more than that. Let's be fair here. Grunts. Groans. You think it's fair that you want something for nothing? In my country. Groaning. We would skin you like a cat. Sobs. Would that be fair? Groaning. I come from nothing. I work all my life serving the people, and then they come into my country and they took it all away, and now they lock me up like a rat. Feed me poison. Is this fair? When Kincaid is dead, you'll be paid in full. Michael, you know he's a murderer, right? You're playing nurse to a murderer. Amelia, a witness. Michael, really? 27 times. That's how many times this asshole has tried to kill me. 27. 28. Fucking Prague. If Dukhovich is acquitted, he'll be back in power next week. I won't let that happen. Good. You should take him to the Hague. I can't. There's a mole inside Interpol. It's already cost me 12 good officers. Good. That's subjective. Size in futility. It's working. Props. But at Meramu, it was a different story. People know that I'm into yoga, and in yoga you breathe from the diaphragm, so I was able to take nice, long deep breaths. Props. Using Peter's breathing technique, Meramu quickly had fire. Woohoo. Keep it going. As night fell on Meramu, Rob and Sarah were immediately drawn to one another. Is it comfy? Oh, yeah, it's like a waterbed. Oh, cool. Dude, I could go to sleep right now. Last night there was definitely flirtation around Rob and Sarah. We fill this thing up and let it cook in the sun all day tomorrow. There you go. We get a hot tub. That's an idea. They got into the raft that we had paddled in on, and they kind just hung out away from everybody else, and, you know, were there pretty much the whole entire night. So at that point, I'm now, that was another, you know, question. Well, what are they saying? You know, are they flirting or are they making an alliance? Rob's, as the sun rose on the morning of day two, Kathy was still determined to start a fire. This is the most important thing right now, so we need to get a group dynamic. How many hours I spent yesterday? I'm wiped. How many hours did you spend yesterday? You tell me. Not many. I don't think we spent more than two. Props. John, for the sake of tribal harmony, decided to work on the fire himself. That's nice. Yes, we got fire. Fire. Yeah. Props. The tribes received their first tree mail. Oh, no, we're on the water. Props. And Roto planned on sticking it to Meramu in the first immunity challenge. This was my luxury item, a voodoo doll. So we're going to put the other team's name on it and start jabbing the hell out of it. Pass it around. Everybody gets a shot. I'll get their swimming feet. I'm going for the shoulder in case we're rowing. It won't go in his head. I'll stick it in the arm and hopefully their arm will be sore. Props. At the challenge, the tribes were told they would be entirely on their own. In addition to no food, no water, you're getting no fire help from us at all, of any kind, at any time. Survivors ready? Go. Woo. Yeah. Props. Roto easily won. And on day 3, the game became a harsh reality as Meramu realized they had to vote out one of their own. My strategy is to keep the strong as possible. Peter got on our nerves a little bit this morning because he came up and called us all over and wanted us to talk about what the strategy of the game was and how he was going to do it. I'm not this magical mystical person. Alright, I think if you want to get the truth on the situation, right, you just can look in someone's eyes. That's not like, oh, some people are going to look you in the eye and lie to you, though. I know you don't have an alliance. I mean, an alliance right now means absolutely nothing. I don't know that. There is no alliance here. I don't know that. Right now the game has shifted from survival to a paranoia state. I believe that Peter has taken it to the extreme. I can see the faces, and I know the outcome of tonight's vote. You don't know what you're talking about. From based on what people are looking, people are tired, people are hungry. It's better for me to talk about it because I won't be able to talk to you tonight. Props, even though Patricia and Sarah received votes, Peter's instincts were correct. He was the first person voted out. First person voted out.
Beavis, hi, butthead. The front door is open. Anyone can come walking into your house. Remember the Katie Beers tragedy?
He said beard.
Not like beer. Like that girl who was kidnapped by a family friend and locked up under that house?
Cool.
Hey, if you two aren't careful, you could get kidnapped too, and held for ransom.
Hey, Stuart. How much money do your parents have?
Oh, I would say more than average.
They got $46?
Oh, even more than that. In fact,
Stuart, do you think they, love you?
Of course they love me. I'm their only son and, well...
Hey, Stuart, wanna watch TV with us?
Yeah, wow. This is great, hanging with you guys.
Yeah. I have to go to the bathroom. Hey, Beavis, come with me for a second.
Choke your own chicken, dude. What's wrong with you?
You, have to, just come here.
No way! Ow! What's your problem, butthole?
Whoa. That was pretty cool.
Yeah. Check it out, butthead, that little dude.
What are you talking about, Beavis?
Wasn't that a kid from Webster?
Oh, yeah. Is this Skinner?
Yeah.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah.
Hey, Arnold. Where are Willis and Kimberly?
I wonder if they're in the same jail.
Yeah. Right alongside Danny Bonaducci.
Danny Bonaducci. Bonaducci.
Check this out. He's gonna say it.
Say it,
bum wipe.
What you talking about?
We have to call Stu's parents now and ask for money, remember?
Oh, yeah. Here, you talk and disguise your voice.
Hello.
And thanks for calling.
We're not here to take your call.
But if you leave a message at the sound of the tone,
we'll get back to you in two shakes of a lamb's tail. Good, honey.
We're like kidnappers or something, and we want some, money.
Yeah.
Call us back, immediately.
That's cool.
Hi, guys. You're back just in time for Full House. That Uncle Joey's funny, huh?
This sucks.
Yeah. We should've kidnapped someone cool.
Yes.
Cool. Wipe that room.
No, you didn't, liar. You stood outside and tried to sneak in.
No way, butthead.
Then you got your ass kicked by that big fat bouncer and tried to sneak backstage.
No way, butthead. I'm talking about it the other night. I'm not there.
Yeah, right, liar. Now keep your mouth shut. This video is cool.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Maybe they were nice. Amelia, I'll make it simple for you. If I stay near him, they'll find him. Michael, so I gotta risk my life protecting this coffin magnet following me. What? Because he hates you. I hate you, too, right now. This place makes you crazy. You know, we came in hellbent on not gambling, and what did we do? We gambled and we lost all our money. You know what I say? House always wins. What if we were the house? Frank, are you guys familiar with the cliche? It's a cliche because it's true. Well, that cliche about cliches being true has never been more true than right now with the cliche. The house always wins. What, Frank? Okay, now, we stand to make 4 years tuition in 1 month. 1 month, guys. Think about that. This is the most impressive thing you've ever done. Frank, Kate, thanks. Scott, I'm very wary to go into business with you. Noted. However, we know why we need the money. Yes. What's in it for you? Well, full disclosure, the bank has foreclosed on my home. Oh, Frank. Ah, there we go. So, this money would help me get that back. That's pretty much why Raina left me. Kate, no, that's not why Raina left you. It's because you started gambling on golf. Yeah, true. Well, not just golf, but okay. And you developed an online porn addiction. Okay, it's not an addiction if you can quit anytime you want, which I can. Then stop. I don't want to right now. Listen, I know I'm throwing a lot of numbers at you guys, a lot of financials, but let's not take away from the fact that this is gonna be fun. Okay, but we're not doing it for fun, right? No, we aren't. No, it's work. I think we're saying the same thing. All of us work hard, play hard, everybody has fun. I think this slide will explain it. Frank, ayo, laughs. Frank, look at that. Well, it just says fun. Frank, it's fun. Scott, but it just says fun. Yeah, it's gonna be a great time, probably the best time of our lives, and we're gonna make crazy money. The graphics are great, but it doesn't help us. It doesn't. I have one last slide to show you, and I think it's the most important. Check this out. Look at Alex, right? Here she is. She's gone to college, but now, top of her class, built her own company. If she doesn't go to college, boom. She's a homeless prostitute. She's a runaway on the streets, selling her tiny body for money. I don't like this. This is very emotionally manipulative. Yeah, exactly. May I speak with you privately, please? Right now. Yes, I'd love to talk to you in the kitchen, if I could. Okay, well, thumbs up, right? I mean, the math. It seems to check out. Do this math. You're 40 years old and you go to jail for 20 years. How old are you when you get out? 90. 100. No, honey. If I have some scratch paper. Nice to see you, sir. So, I had a question for you, sir. Okay, hit me with it. Do you have any advice on how to get adopted? Oh, yeah. Oh, you do. Mr. Wing, can I get an autograph? Sure. Alright. For example, is teeth whitener a good idea? Yes, there you go, pal. Thanks. Really? Oh, yeah. Looking good, Bruce. Thank you so much. How about eyeliner or a foreign language? Try both. Wait, no. Look, it's the new commissioner. Where? Oh, she's with the mayor. Okay, let's see. Here she is, everyone. Oh, my darling. Hi, dad. Gasps. Romantic music playing. Dick, Mr. Wayne, should I get experimental surgery to make my eyes larger and more vulnerable looking? Do that. Laughing. Mr. Wayne, are you currently in the market to adopt a child? Yeah, really? Oh, yeah. Laughs. Wow. Are you looking for more of a base model orphan or one that has more upgraded features? Yeah, like cooking or driftwood art, gymnastic abilities? Yeah, yeah. Close-up street magic a la David Blaine? All of it sounds great. Really? Because all of it sounds like me. Mr. Wayne, do you think you'd be interested in adopting me as your future orphan son? Definitely. Oh, this is great. Because all I want is to get adopted so I can finally stop being alone. McCaskill, we've gathered here tonight to mark the retirement of Jim Gordon. Goodbye. And we wish him well on his South African jungle safari. All cheering. Thank you. Now, to introduce you to his exciting new replacement. Everyone, meet your new commissioner. Pop music playing. Announcer, meet Barbara Gordon, the new commissioner of Gotham City. Whoa, she was top of her class at Harvard for police. She cleaned up the streets of Gotham's nearby sister city, Bloodhaven, using statistics and compassion. And now she's bringing her new ideas and her new cucks to Gotham City. Congratulations, darling. Thanks, Dad. Here she is, everyone. Thank you. Thanks. Hooray. Reporter 1, Ms. Gordon, over here. Reporter 2, big smile. Wow, thank you for the oversized key to Arkham Asylum. And, what's this? Thank you for the switch to the bat signal. Nice. Clears throat. Dad, you've always done a great job protecting Gotham City. Blip. Chuckles. That's me. Thank you. Along with Batman, of course. Who? Let's hear it for Batman, who I wish was here right now. Bruce. Oh, I'm sure he's listening. I'd like to ask all of you a question. Are you fed up with crime? Uh-huh. We're all tired of crime. Yeah, we're sick of it. Great. Then let's talk about real improvements that will end the cycle of crime. I've got a 4-point pilot program that I'd love to share with you. I want to hear all 4 points. It's called I Am Ready. It takes a village. Best opening to a title ever. Not a Batman. Girls. Lucy. You're a girl, right? Let's just say there's this girl I'd like to impress, but she's something and I'm nothing. If I were something and she was nothing, I could talk to her. Or, if she was nothing and I was nothing, I could talk to her, but she's something and I'm nothing, so I just can't talk to her. You're being ridiculous, Charlie Brown. You have much to offer. She has a pretty face and pretty faces make me nervous. Pretty face? Pretty face? I have a pretty face. How come my face doesn't make you nervous? How come you can talk to me, Charlie Brown? Charlie Brown groans. I just need to know the secret to winning her heart. Look into this mirror, Charlie Brown. This is the face of failure. A classic failure face. Do you think girls like failures, Charlie Brown? Well, no. Girls want someone with proven success. Have you won any awards, like a Congressional Medal of Honor, or a Nobel Peace Prize? What are your real estate holdings? Do you have a diversified portfolio? Huh. Let me let you in on a little secret, Charlie Brown. If you really want to impress girls, you need to show them you're a winner. A winner? Me. Lucy, you may be onto something. Of course, when I say you know I don't mean you personally. Lucy clears throat. That will be 5 cents, please. Size. Nickels, nickels, nickels. What a beautiful sound. Congratulations. You're now on your way to becoming a winner. Step 1. Forget everything you ever knew about yourself. Teen. I am so out of here. Emancipation. Emancipation. Mobility. Music. Are you making fun of me, Gardner? No, Tulsa. I just wish I could go with you. You've been saying that since last summer. And you can't. No, I can't. Oh, right. You can't leave your house. It's not a house. It's a penthouse on Park Avenue. I can't leave because of my disease. Osteogenesis imperfecta. Tulsa. Yeah, still don't believe you. Gardner, wouldn't your foster dad be unhappy? Yeah, no more checks from the state. School bell rings. Study lab is over. Gotta go. See ya in the funny papers. What does that mean? You always say that. What does it mean? I don't know. I had a foster sister in Oklahoma who used to say it all the time. Just a different way of saying goodbye. I like it. Talk tomorrow. I'm not going anywhere. Man speaks indistinctly on TV. Where'd you get this movie? One of the German scientists who was here last month left it behind. How do you know what's going on? Speaking German. Chuckles. Excuse me. It's easy. You see those men there? They're angels. They look over the people on Earth and make sure they're okay. You see that angel? He's gonna fall in love with her and fall to her. The tribe. Peter. The tribe has spoken. On day 4, the mood at Meramu was upbeat. The tribe awoke to Sean's radio program. You got today's weather report, Hunter. Hold on. Let me change the station. Hunter Ellis with today's morning weather. Props. At Roto it was all work and no play until Kathy found food. Whistling. Hey, you guys, get over here. I'm serious. We got 7. 1, 2, 3, 4. Whoa, that was slimy. I know, but a lot of meat here. A lot of protein we're looking at. Props. And to flavor up their meal, Gabe added some spice to the mix. These are peppers. Peppers. Way to go, guys. Way to go, guys. Ah, coconut, lime, and peppers. Put in some more peppers. That looks yummy. Wow, wow, God, that's good. Props. Back at Meramu, Rob was trying out some inventive cooking of his own. I'm going to fry up a little papaya. I have no idea how this is going to turn out. I'm not going to eat it until you eat it. It's your concoction. It's pretty good. It tastes like warm papaya. What do you think? Props. But Patricia wanted to get the chores done. Here's the plan. You all get ready and go gather some coconuts, and we're going to finish getting these flat rocks. How can we get coconuts without a stick? Well, he'll get you a stick. He's a great stick hunter. Work needs to get done, and if somebody is not going to step up to the plate, I don't mind telling somebody, look, let's go. First it was endearing, because it just seemed natural. Now it just seemed like, oh, no, Mama got to work. Mama can't sit down. Now listen to me, I'm only going going to tell you this once. I heard it this morning already once. Tool tree. I already heard it. I know everything needs to go back where you find it. I know. I'm tired of trying to. Where's the knife then? Probst. On day 5, the tribes competed for some valuable fishing gear. Want to know what you're playing for? Yeah. Probst. Mask. Snorkel. Fins. Yeah. Probst. Survivors ready? Go. Rotu. Cheering. Rotu won the mask and fins, but there were more victories to come. What do we got today? Oh my god, it's a 4. Probst. Getting a utensil in the mail on day 6 could only mean one thing. A food challenge. Yeah. Probst. And it was. The tribes had to eat a Marquesan delicacy of fish soaking in fermented sea water. Rob choked and Maramu lost their 3rd challenge in a row. So Maramu headed back to tribal council, where in a 4-3 vote, Patricia, known as the tribe's mom, was voted out. Patricia, the tribe has spoken. Maramu lost their 2nd tribe member. It's time for you to go. Day 7 would prove to be a lesson in pain for Rotuk. While snorkeling for food, John was the first victim. I landed right on top of a sea urchin, and embedded about 12 sea urchin needles in my fingers. I got to go back in and get somebody to pee on it. That's what you're supposed to do from that kind of a venomous sting from a sea urchin is to urinate on it. I need somebody who can pee on my hand. Someone have to go to the bathroom. Probst. Luckily, someone did. I didn't even think it was weird that she was squatting down and I had my hand between her legs. Good thing you had to go to the bathroom. Laughing. Probst. On day 8, bamboo and rope were delivered to the tribes.
This song is called Welcome to Planet MF.
Yeah, yeah. What do you think MF stands for?
Pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah, pretty cool.
This kidnapping sucks.
Yeah. Let's tape him to the floor and drool on him.
Hey, Beavis. You know, we could, like, go to jail for this.
Yeah, that would be cool. We can, like, lift weights and get tattoos.
Get the remote from him.
Oh, give me that.
Yeah, Stuart, you can't watch and eat at the same time. We'll get carsick.
Yeah, yeah, carsick.
Let's watch something cool.
Butthead. Come on, Butthead, this is supposed to be the change.
No way. The song gets cool later.
Where's that in there? Oh, darling, darling, darling.
Come on, Butthead, we can watch something else, then we can change it back when it's cool.
Damn it, Beavis, it's gonna get cool.
So much.
Let go of your hang-up.
So much.
Oh, yeah.
So much.
Yes!
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I told you, dude.
Yeah, yeah, this video was cool.
I like it too, but you don't have to slobber all over me. These guys have all done it.
Yeah, yeah.
I bet these guys have done it more than once.
Yeah, yeah. That's when you're really cool.
Hey, this is really fun. You guys up for Urkel and some cheddar corn?
This sucks.
Yeah. When's his mom gonna call?
Did I do that?
Come on over, guys.
This sucks. I can't take it anymore.
Yeah, let's call his mom.
I already called, like, this many times.
Maybe his parents don't want him back.
Would you?
Oof, Balky! I love him!
What do we do now?
Hey, Stuart, leave.
What?
Go away. Get out of my house.
Oh, well, all right. I'm going to hit the Star Trek convention at the Days Inn. George, Mr. Sulu, Takai is going to be there. Then I'm going to the Civic Amphitheater for the Mucho Metal concert.
Huh?
Whoa.
My plate is full. Later, amigos. That's Spanish for pals.
He's going and we're not.
I fought Mucho Metal without Beavis and Butthead? No way! Look, I'm frenzy!
This is a cool concert. How come we're having such a sucky time?
If you're a romantic, then he won't be an angel anymore. He'll be just like her. School bell rings, wings fluttering, indistinct conversation, boys laughing, music playing. Boy one, hey, Tulsa, give us a ride, you slut. I got a Harley you can ride. Tulsa, come here, come back here, you slut. Indistinct shouting, dog barking. Hey, boy, what up, Chuck? Don't get up cause of me. TV playing. Hey, honey, how was your day? Make any new friends yet? Oh, you bet. Boy, am I fighting them off? SpongeBob. Hey, SpongeBob, I found this flyer. Gary's missing. SpongeBob sniffling. I know, Patrick. SpongeBob. Oh, Patrick, if something were to happen to Gary, I don't know what I'd do. I'm sorry, buddy. Hey, maybe he left a clue. Dash toy squeaks. Oh, gasps. Look, a clue. Gasps. Gary's been snail napped. and taken to the lost city of Atlantic City. Chewing, oh, really? That's awesome. It's now we know where he is. MM, not really that awesome. Patrick, listen to this. Made famous by the glitzy palace Poseidon calls home. The lost city of Atlantic City is a scary, vice-ridden cesspool of moral depravity. Wow, all that, and it's lost too. King Poseidon has proven himself a whimsical tyrant, known for executing his subjects by beheading them. In a flamboyant floor show extravaganza, our advice for those traveling here is don't. Gulps, this King Poseidon sounds like a tough customer. Oh, yeah, tough. Ah, so what? This is about friends. And friends don't let friends become somebody else's face cream. Not what friends do. So what if it's dangerous and scary? So what? What is stopping me right now from going there, rescuing Gary, and standing up to this King Poseidon? I don't know. Well, I do. What is it? I don't have the courage. Sniffling. Wailing. Oh, Gary. Tartar sauce. What's the next best thing to courage? Resolve. No. Fortitude. Nah. Commitment. No. Wherewithal. Bravery. No. Valor. Grit. What? No. Heroism. Gallantry. Nah. Moxie. A buddy. A wingman. A wingman. A friend. Really? Patrick, you'd go with me? Yeah. Right behind you. Do I smell a road trip? Gasps. That could be my breath. Both laughing. Okie dokie. Now, let's drill down on a plan. Pat, you're in charge of transpo. Just remember, I don't drive and you don't have a car. Lecter? I dabble. I don't dabble. This cross has a very tragic history. 18 men died trying to hold onto it. So much blood so needlessly spilled. Gavel tapping. Auctioneer. Ladies and gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please. Good luck to you. Auctioneer, would you please take your seats? The auction will be commencing very soon. Exhales. Sully over earbud. Hey, Bubble Yum. You done chatting up our arch nemesis? I'm pretty sure he just threatened to kill me. Don't touch your ear like that. You look like an idiot. Get a move on. Auctioneer. Now, most of you may be well aware of the fact that Nate gonna make my way upstairs. Auctioneer are made from some of the most exciting items, many of which are exceedingly rare from our Spanish Renaissance collection. Nate over earbud. Your girlfriend seems pissed. Is that something I should be worried about? Sully, just stay focused. Auctioneer. So, once again, keep an eye on him for me. Auctioneer, if you would, please come and take your seats. Thank you very much. Door lock beeps. Excuse me. Okay, let's get started then. With lot number one, a magnificent oil on copper. Our Lady of Good Counsel by Bartolome Pires. Hello. 600,000. Going once, going twice. Sold to the lady in the back. Applause. Thank you very much. The cross is up next. Kid. Tool whirring. Sully, don't worry. I got it. Sizzles. Groans. Auctioneer. La Cruz de la Hermandad. Now, most of you will know this was made in Barcelona, circa 16th century. It is truly a gorgeous piece and representative of Spanish Renaissance gold work. So, we're gonna start off tonight's bidding at 200,000. Do I have 200,000 in the room? Thank you very much. I have an opening bid of 200,000 from Mr. Moncada. Nate, okay, here we go. Do I hear four? How are we doing? We're doing great. Auctioneer, 500,000 it is. Do I have six? I have six. Thank you very much, madam. I don't have all night. Auctioneer, do I have seven? 700,000 from Mr. Moncada. Do we come? We'll walk away from the company, the family, tonight. What are you up to? Distant gunfire. Rapid gunfire. Grunts. Chair vibrating. Distant gunfire. Snorts. Vibrating stops. Gunfire continues. Groaning. Gunfire continues. Grunting. Panting quietly. Whimpering. Candy cane yells. Grunts. Let's go. We need to get you out of here. Mommy, where are you going? She's going for the panic room. What? Yes, go. Bird brood. Without us. Gunfire continues. Groaning. Grunts. Alba. Fuck. 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 Gunfire. Gertrude. There isn't room for all of us. She can fit at least two of us. Mom. Take me. Mom. Stammers. Oh, yeah. And mom. Can bird come too? Device beeps. Whirring. Okay. Move it or lose it. Son. Move it. Whoa. 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 You're supposed to protect us. We protect the primary asset. Who the hell are you? You can call me Mr. Scrooge. Hilarious. Get him. Grunting and groaning. Bah humbug. Motherfucker. Scrooge. Hey. Step aside. Tinsel. Peppermint. Sweep upstairs. I want all the light stones together. Kill anybody else you find. Panting. Whimpering. Fuck. 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 Linda. Trudy. Honey. We got to go. Jason. Wake up, honey. Wake up. Maybe we can get out the back by the servant's stairs. Gasps. Crackles. Whistles. Oh, come on. Not now. Not now. Crackles. Whistles. Fuck. Fuck. Mistletoe. Gingerbread. Crackles. Whistles. Gasps. Banging. Hey. Jingling. Oh. Oh. Chuckling hot. You got me. I don't want any trouble. Okay. Downstairs. Now. Look, mister. I don't want to get involved. I just have a job to do. Okay. That's it. I'm just gonna take my bag. And I'm just gonna switch up that chimney. Both grunt. Enough talk. Let's go. You don't want to do this. What? This. Both grunt. Now. Move. Groaning. Are you deaf? Fucking move. Tinsel gasps. Grunting. Snorting. Grunting. Rapid hoofbeats. No. 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 Wait. 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 Don't go. Come back. Grunting. Both yelling. Grunting and groaning. Sizzling. Screaming. Steam hissing. Groaning. Both yelling. Grunting. Groaning. Crackling. Whistling. Grunting and groaning. Strain. Grunting. Screaming. Today. Stammers. It's basically an iPhone. You know, it doesn't play music or you can't call, but they couldn't get the file. That's okay. You'll find a place. Well, I think it's great. Mom. Maybe. Thank you. So Ogie. Okay. Ogie, yeah? How was your first day of school? Earth to Ogie. We asked you a question. Come on. How was your day? Good. Good how? Good like it was good. Or good like it was bad and you just don't want to tell us. It was good. Okay. I just don't know what you want me to say. It was good. Okay. Okay. Hey. If you're mad at mom about going to school, it was my idea too. Why can't I just say good like anybody else? Batting 1,000 today. Are they gonna ask about my day? That is not the way we leave the table. Hey, come on. Talk to me. Sit down. Take that off, please. Dash voice breaking. I'm sorry. Dash Isabel. It's okay. It'll be okay. Why do I have to be so ugly? You are not ugly. Okay. You just have to say that because you're my mom. Oh, because I'm your mom. It doesn't count? Yeah. Because I'm your mom. It counts the most because I know you the most. You are not ugly and anyone who cares to know you will see that. They won't even talk to me. It matters that I look different. I try to pretend that it doesn't, but it does. I know. Is it always gonna matter? I don't know. Honey, listen. Look at me. We all have marks on our face. I have this wrinkle here from your first surgery. I have these wrinkles here from your last surgery. This is the map that shows us where we're going. And this is the map that shows us where we've been. And it's never ever ugly. But what about your gray hair? Chuckling softly. That's, to what do we owe this honor? Props. I come bearing supplies for your next challenge. At Rotu, the tribe was dealt a painful blow again. A big rock got in between my shoe and my foot and just sliced up my toe nicely. Props. And again. Don actually stuck his hand underneath the rock and an eel bit him. Oh my god. What is going on? Shouting. Props. But not even injuries could stop a closely knit Rotu tribe as they beat Meramu in a tight finish in the reward challenge. Rotu, ready to rock. Everybody wants to go. Props. Meramu set out for a hike on day 9. Patricia went for a hike one day by herself. Found a stream on the other side of the hill. So I think that could be something that we need to go check out. It's also a good opportunity for us all to get out and and do something together as a tribe. Is the creek definitely down there? It ends down there. It's pretty direct. It's just it's steep. This is doing a whole lot for me. I thought it was an easy walk to the creek. It comes right out of the rocks, a little bit to the side of where I think the river is going to come out. But after all of this, we're going to spend 10 minutes and leave, and then climb back up. Hunter, he's just up and always busy. The thing is, we didn't come here to exert ourselves in this tropical heat. Damn all this other work. We need energy to get those damn challenges. Robstko. In the immunity challenge, the tribes battled it out in a coconut maze race. In the hole, here we go. Yeah, Robst, Meramu lost yet again. So Rob strategized behind the scenes and became the tribe's puppet master. It's important for me to have people on my team that are going to do what I tell them to do. Game always keeps you thinking. It really does. Fear keeps people loyal. If they're afraid, they have something to lose, and they'll do what they tell you to do. That's straight out of The Godfather. It's true. Robst, it was a shocking tribal council, as Meramu voted out the strongest member of their tribe. Hunter, the tribe has spoken. First step, pick a disc. Doesn't matter. It's totally random. Follow your gut. Go wherever you want. On day 10, the tribes came together for the biggest twist in the game yet. Okay, Zoe, you're first. Step off your disc. Pull off your new buff. Take your old one off. Put your new one on. The tribes were randomly switched up. Some friendships remained together. Yeah, Pappy's on our team. We got Pappy. Robst, while others were torn apart. Rob, you're now a member of Rotu. Sarah, alright, Sarah, same buff. Still a member of Meramu, but for the remaining 13 survivors, all bets were off. It was time to play a brand new game. At Meramu, Kathy, Pascal, and Nelly were pleased with their new camp. That forest is so beautiful. Well, let's show you guys around. This is a breadfruit. This is a mango tree. All you got to do is pick up the limes off the ground. I just got off of a tribe that would get up at dawn, check the pig pit, you know, and go out and forage for shells. So to us, we feel like it was a 4-star hotel and that there's fruit on the table, so it was pretty nice. Props for the new members of Rotu. Life seemed pleasant as well. They were ecstatic when they saw their new water source. Yeah, it is so, so good. I didn't even know what else to say. I'm loving it. Good. I'm glad to hear it. I am loving it. Now.
Ooh-wee. These boys from Slayer really know how to shed. Duck tape my head.
Cut it out.
Draw it off the top, dude.
No thank you. I don't like stuff that sucks.
I know. Let's start a wave.
Woo-hoo-hoo. Faster, Beavis. Someone might see us.
Great for the once, bro. Noonsy, noonsy, very noonsy. Naughty, 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 naughty. The sign of West Coast, a sweet face, and he goes by the name of Ebony. He's waiting in the city as a man. He's waiting by the time. He's still fine. He's still fine. He's still fine.
These guys are from that country where everything sucks. People from that country are stupid. I do say, old chap, time to choke my chicken.
Yeah, very well, right? Slow down! Slow down! Slow down!
Yeah, slow down or shut up.
Slow down. Uh-oh. I feel a seizure coming on.
That was cool.
Yeah.
At least something good came out of this video.
Yeah, yeah.
I feel really badly that we got separated from your friends, honey.
Oh, don't worry, Mother. When a boy gets to be Stu's age, he can take care of himself. Okay, son, up to bed now.
We're like kidnappers or something. And we want some, money.
Yeah.
Call us back.
Oh, no. Beavis and Butthead have been kidnapped.
Is this Stu's dad? We're the kidnappers.
Hide your voice.
Shut up, Beavis. We want some money.
Yeah.
Stuart's parents? Yeah. Hello? Never mind.
What's this crap?
Yeah, this chick looks like that one porno star.
No way, Beavis, that's a chick from that Hairspray movie.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Beavis, this chick's real name is Deborah Harry.
Yeah.
So, like, if you looked up her name in the phone book, it would say, Harry Deborah.
How come?
I don't know. They always put them backwards.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this dork.
Yeah. What is it? Battle of the dorks?
I think we have a winner.
I think we have a winner.
This looks like one of those commercials for KTEL Records.
Yeah.
Hey, Beavis, I hear disco is making a comeback.
Yeah. Just dial 1-800-WOOD.
Whoa. Beastie Boys are cool.
Yeah, yeah. Check it out, Butthead. Don't even play their own...
Compliments of your dad, I think. Chuckles. And as though we summoned him. Dash chuckles dash okay, how was your day? My day is really good right now. So they went to Florida, where Gollum was living in Miami. And, oh, you know what it is? Daddy doesn't have his glasses on. You're making this up. All laughing. By August is the sun. My mom and dad and me are planets orbiting the sun. But I love my brother and I'm used to the way this universe. I have to go. I know. Or at least I know I cannot stop you. There is so much you do not understand. I understand enough that I'm willing to fight for those who cannot fight for themselves. Like you once did. You know that if you choose to leave, you may never return. Who will I be if I stay? This belonged to the greatest warrior in our history. Our beloved Antiope. Make sure you are worthy of it. I will. Be careful in the world of men. Diana. They do not deserve you. You have been my greatest love. Today. You are my greatest sorrow. Should you have told her? The more she knows, the sooner he'll find her. How long until we reach the war? The war? Which part? The Western Front in France is 400 miles long from the Alps to the North Sea, where the fighting is the most intense. Then, if you take me there, I'm sure I'll find Ares. Ares, as in, the god of war? The god of war is our responsibility. Only an Amazon can defeat him. With this size. And once I do, the war will end. Metal clans. Steve clears throat. Look, I appreciate your spirit, but this war is, it's a great big mess, and there's not a whole lot you and I can do about that. I mean, we can get back to London, and try to get to the men who can. I'm the man who can, and once I find and destroy Ares, the German armies will be free from his influence, and they will be good men again, and the world will be better. Great, you'll see. What are you doing? Oh, I thought maybe you'd want to get some sleep. And what about you? Are you not sleeping? Does the average man not sleep? Stammering. Yes, we sleep. We just don't sleep with, you don't sleep with women? No, I mean, I do sleep with, I sleep with. Chuckles. Yes, I do, but out of the, clears throat, confines of marriage. It's just, it's not polite to assume, you know. Marriage, marriage, do you not have that on? You go before a judge, and you swear to love, honor, and cherish each other. Until death do you part, and do they love each other till death? Not very often, no. Then why do you understand? Dash balloon pops dash gasps. Children shouting and laughing. When I say that something, I want to hold your hand. Balloon pops. Jack singing whisper words of wisdom. Let it be. Inhales sharply. People speaking indistinctly. People speaking indistinctly. People speaking indistinctly in distance. Excuse me. Yeah, are you the manager? Uh-huh. I'm Gavin. Panting. Hey, are you okay? It's me. That's the problem. That's the awful truth. The revelation. I know the songs are strong, but no one's interested still. Jack Malik's the problem. Dash Ellie, that's not true. It is. I just don't have it. That's the difference between Jay-Z and Dash scoffs. JY dash chuckles. Well, then how do you explain this? You're gonna be a recording artist, Mr. Malik. Jack singing in background because she loves you. Ellie laughs and squeals. And you know that can't be bad. I'd be very happy to help. Or free. My studio at your service. Gavin, you're cool. Emma, she loves you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And with a love like that, you know you should be glad. Train horn blows. With a love like that, you know you should. Windows rattling. Be glad. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yes, 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 we've got it. Yes, we have reached the mountaintop. Yeah, 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 yeah. Dash laughing. Do you like it, Gavin? I absolutely love it. Ellie, oh, laughing. Sighs. Jack, you got any more songs? One or two? Oh, yeah, I'll tell you something. I think you'll understand. When I say that something, I want to hold your hand. Now, let me hold your hand. I want to hold your hand. And when I touch you, I feel happy inside. It's such a feeling that my love laughs. I can't hide. I can't hide. I can't hide. Laughing. Well, she was just 17. You know what I mean. And the way she looked was way beyond compare. Ellie who? She wouldn't dance with another who? Oh, when I saw her standing there. Have a listen. Ha, exciting. Dash man, how much? Oh, no charge. It's free with any purchase. Songs with your Snickers. Music with your multi-packs. Oh, thank you. Tunes with your chunks of cheddar cheese. Jack. Ryan, and here's a lovely little story. Jack, you work in the wholesale warehouse in Lowestoft, and we hear members of the retail trade have been getting a free CD, along with their jumbo boxes of Nescafe and washing powder. That's right, but you're gonna sing us a new song now. So here's Jack Malik, the singing wholesaler in my life. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you, and these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection or people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them in my life. I love you. Strange noise. Yeah, I've been hearing some strange noises too. Oh, yeah, that was us having sex. Rule number one. Yeah, maybe rule number 32 for her. What? Hey, okay, ready, go. Okay, let's go. Come on, Tallahassee. Oh, fuck, shit, honey, I'm home. Oh, my god, you're back. I mean, you're back or whatever. That's cool. I'm not staying. I came to get weapons. At 1 o'clock in the morning? Yeah, after a month missing. Little Rock's gone. It was great. It felt so good to be on the move again. We've been having a really good time here too. Together, we picked up someone new. Just a boy. He's a couple years older than Little Rock, and he's from Berkeley. Berkeley. Don't worry about a thing. Tallahassee. You said Berkeley? Yes, Tallahassee. Berk fucking lay. Cause every little thing. Wichita. He plays the guitar. Shut the fuck up right now. I know what you're about to tell me. She's dating a musician. Come on. Don't you think you're, like, overreacting a little bit? Yeah, yeah. No, I could be overreacting. I'm sorry. You're right. You go ahead. And he's a pacifist. He has survived on a strict policy of conflict avoidance, like Gandhi. No, no. Birkenstocks, sandals, wheatgrass, fucking basketballs. Tallahassee yells, breathing heavily. No, I have nothing against pacifists. I just want to beat the shit out of them. This is my message to you. Applause. Wow, I mean, you have a beautiful voice. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah, hey, have you ever heard of this place, Graceland? Elvis was a fraud. He ripped off the black man. Oh, I don't know. I've just always wanted to go there. Yeah, me too. Yeah, Graceland would be cool. Yeah, yeah, it would be. Wichita. I was adamant it was a dumb idea, so I did what I never do with her. I told her no. You can guess what happened next. Tires squealing, panting. She left a note, and then she hit the road. Giggles. Does anyone else get the irony in that? I'm so worried, you guys. They're traveling all that way, and all they have is a fucking guitar. Yeah, with no intention of ever swinging it at anything. You know, because he's a hippie. She's supposed to be killing the dead, not following them. Oh god, there's something going on out there. What? Berkeley told us about this new kind of zombie that's stronger and faster and deadlier and better adapted to the hunt. I'm sorry, but that sounds totally made up. If you want us to come with you, just ask us. Honestly, I just came. Puts us at 73 minutes behind. I gotta go in. Cover me. You're on your own. Color of sweater that I do, but I can't see colors very well. Isn't that funny? Don't. Look at that. Look at that. I'm sorry, son. He's talking to you. Okay, sweetie. Honey, honey. All right, woman. Don't do that, sweetheart. That sword looks awfully sharp and heavy too. Not really. No. Well, you must be very strong in order to hold it like that. And I bet you are very strong on the inside too. Well, Rogers chuckles. Oh, I like that. Thank you. Yes, right. I terribly sorry, Brett. We, they see this, I'm like, hey, you know, this ain't too bad. Singing, Provst, on day 11, Sean introduced his new tribe to the radio program. Girl, you know you, singing. When we landed here on Rota Camp, we told them about some of the things that we did on our camp, like the early morning show, and they were more than willing to try it. No longer are they down with the Meramu. We could never say our name right, so I'm not going to say it right this morning. Rota can do. That's right, Rota can do. And we're going to head over and get a food report from our main chef, Johnny Pots and Pans. At first I thought we might all start off with a little raw coconut, and if we go searching pretty hard, we might find ourselves some sea urchins, but watch those spines. Back to you. These three new members brought, I guess, a sense of humor that I don't think we had before, and it was fun. Why don't you give us an overall report on things on this island? How are things going on the Marquesan Islands with Australian accent? Well, we're all settling into our new habits, looking for a new place to hang up some clothes, find a place to sleep, all try to get together. I'm sure we can do it in the speed of the Thames here. I'm sure we can pull through in the end. Back to you, Ra. They seemed like they enjoyed it. We all can sit around and have fun and laugh and bond in other ways than just working. The Inn people will be sporting lovely new buffs. You can wrap them around your head in any manner whatsoever. You can sit down and self-disclose yourself and laugh, and seemed like the radio show was well received. That concludes our wake-up show for this morning. Stay tuned tomorrow, same time, same station. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a good day, and remember, God loves you. Provst, the two new tribes squared off against each other in an immunity challenge on day 12. Today's immunity challenge is all about the weaving. Each of you have a woven tapestry that is scrambled. It's very simple. The first tribe to unscramble it correctly wins immunity. Losing tribe, tribal council, tonight with me. But Rota continued to function like a well-oiled machine, and they beat Meramu again. Here it comes. That's it, that's it, that's it right there. Provst, Rota, Rota, yes, all right. Provst, so the new Meramu headed to tribal council, where the old Rota members, along with Gina, voted Sarah out. Sarah, the tribe has spoken. Paranoia swept over Rota on day 13, and John became suspicious when Gabe said he wasn't there to play the game. What are the ethics in this game? To me, it's tell the truth, be honest. Are you saying that you would lie to win this game? I'm not even here to play the game, man. Gabriel said he's not playing the game. I don't believe it. I mean, you are here to play this game. You're not here on a commune. You know, this is not the 60s. And, you know, free love and all that kind of stuff. Provst, to solidify his position, John decided to create an alliance with Tammy, the general, and Zoe, with Gabe to be their first victim. Basically, I want four people that I know will not vote for me, just plain and simple. So what we're shooting for is the final four is myself, you, Tammy, and Rob. Just voting is block. Trust me 100%. I mean, I don't even know what else I can say to you. Split my hand open and rub blood on you. I mean, I have your back. I mean, you are my partner. You swear you're not playing me.
Yeah. I wish I could rock like this. Look at his pants.
Yeah. Can't have his pants do that sometimes.
Yeah. So he's on cool. Hey, who's that?
That's like an extra beefy boy.
Whoa. You mean they've got, four of them now?
Yeah. What's that guy?
Oh, yeah. Look at his face.
Yeah, yeah. His face is cool.
If I had a face like that, I would, like, be pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Check it out. A giraffe.
Yeah, giraffe is cool.
Hey, you gonna stare all day or are you gonna buy something?
I'm gonna stare all day.
Hey, buddy, check it out.
Whoa, an ad with naked people. Cool.
Look, there.
Oh, yeah. Words. Sunny Grove Nudist Call, Nude... Nude people. We're there, dude.
Is this Pearl Jam?
Yeah. Any better guy than Aaron.
Wait a minute, isn't it Pearl Jam?
Yeah. It's good to see you thinking, Beavis. That guy makes faces like Eddie Vedder.
No way. Eddie Vedder makes faces like this guy.
They both make faces like that John Belushi dude.
Yeah, what he said.
I heard these guys like came first, and Pearl Jam ripped them off.
No way, buddy. Pearl Jam came first.
Well, they both suck.
Hey, buddy. Pearl Jam doesn't suck. They're from Seattle.
Oh, yeah.
That bear is cool.
It takes a lot more than bears to make a video cool, Beavis.
What if the bear was like taking a dump?
Well, that might work. I want to dye my hair orange.
Yes. You look good, buddy. You should do it.
Yeah.
Sunny Grove Nudist Colony, please hold.
We came to see naked girls.
Yeah, yeah.
Mr. Blackstone will see you shortly.
Is he naked?
That's
Sunny Grove, our philosophy is simple. We believe nudity is the body's natural state. We enter the world naked. We shower naked. We make love naked. That's why we share our nudity with others. Of course, we don't want members who are just out for a sexual experience, but you boys seem like a good risk to me.
Naked.
Yeah.
Need to start. Can I take your picture? Yes, yes. Everybody make sure you can see me. Now. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming down and visiting us in the neighborhood. Oaks, if you'll follow me. Okay, thank you. Great job. You did such a good job. How often does this happen? Every day. Okay, here we go. Everybody settle. Quiet, please. Roll sound. Sound speeds. AD. Market. And. Action. Rogers. Ahem. Do you know what this is? It's Lloyd. Lloyd. Hold, please. We can't fire him, can we? Hello, Lloyd. Oh, it's nice to meet you. What? Are you alright? In normal voice play at the plate. Mercy, that looks like it hurts. Let's chat afterwards. We need to keep moving. Have Evan take a look at him. No, I'm good. I'm good. No, I'm sorry. Fred. Yeah, we just need to. Alright, alright. It's wonderful to meet you. So glad you're here. I'm looking forward to talking with you. I truly am. After this, everyone, this is Lloyd Vogel. He is a wonderful writer. AD, thank you. Much fun. Come here, chuckling. Oh god, softly, I almost lost you. I got so scared. You crazy, brilliant scientist. You know, you have great hair. What? No, I don't. Please don't say that. Okay, sus. I had a great time. Your mom is insanely nice. Your house is warm. It smells good, and it's full of, I don't know what, but it's amazing. It's far from amazing. My mom's upstairs in her room preparing for yet another parent-teacher conference for her delinquent daughter. Sus. Oh, no, not now. Come here. Scoffing. Veronica's your neighbor? Meg, yes. Come here, please. So you're embarrassed to be seen with me. Yeah, right. Other way around. She's gonna tell everybody that you were here with me, and I'm just trying to protect your reputation. So can you come here? Calvin, she already saw us. Besides, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. You say that now, but you don't know what it's like, having every move you make mocked and ridiculed. You'd be surprised. Meg, come on, Calvin. Everybody likes you, even the teachers. You do everything perfectly. Scoffs. Tell that to my dad. At least you have your dad. Right, sorry, that. You must really miss him, more than anything in the universe. Then how about we go and find him? I've never understood the point of fences. Wait, stammers, what are you doing here? Door opens. Door closes. This is it, kids. This is it. No, hey, no. You're supposed to be upstairs. Gate opens. You need to get up, get out, and get something. How will you make it if you never even try? Calvin, I know that one. Outcast American. How's it going, Mrs. Who? I did it, Mrs. Who. I got this real research. Flight attendant, hot towel. Oh, thank you. Thank you for flying with us. We do appreciate it. Captain L.U., please prepare for landing. Indistinct chatter. Roy, all the hopes we ever had for space travel. Covered up by drink stands and t-shirt vendors. Just a recreation of what we're running from on Earth. We are world eaters. If my dad could see this now, he'd tear it all down. Man announcing indistinctly on PA. Pruitt, our rocket is named Cepheus. The crew will be Spacecom military personnel. They're completely unaware of our mission. We have to keep it that way. The launch pad is on the other side of no man's land. It's very dangerous, so we'll have armed personnel to protect us and escort us to the far side. Colonel, can I ask what the last conversation you had with my dad was? It was not very pleasant. We quarreled about my leaving the program. He accused me of being a traitor, and if you were to find him, then what? Is this very difficult for you, son? This being about your father? No, no, my dad's a hero. Spacecom's trying to impugn a man who's given his entire life to the program. I think it's despicable. We're desperate at best. Computer chimes. Announcer, on PA, we are approaching Terminal R, Lunar Rover Hangar. We've been having trouble with pirates since September. Some countries have been giving them safe haven. They'll take hostages or go for our rovers. It's like the Wild West out there, but we'll get you to your spacecraft. This your first time in a war zone? 3 years over the Arctic Circle. Levant, alright. And a heck of a lot of Army-Navy games. Chuckles, well, I guess there's not much you haven't seen, right? Well, look, it's almost a full moon. My truest friend. If he's in need, I will help him, no matter what. All cheering. MCTWISPO. Alice, so brave. I knew she'd help us. Where exactly is this chronosphere? In the hands of time. It's his. I'm sorry. Time is a he. He lives in a void of infinitude. In a castle of eternity. Through here. 1 mile past the pendulum. All gasping. Wind whooshing. MCTWISP. Very cold. Einstein's castle. Horror of the chronosphere. Travel back in time to Horan Vendish Day. Save the Hatter's family from being killed. And thereby save the Hatter. And do try not to break the past, present, or future. SHH. I was only trying to help. Both. What could go wrong? Gasping. MCTWISP. Breathing heavily. Bear Farron. Alice. Hatter's counting on you. We all are. Breathing heavily. Yelps. Panting. Groans. Yelps. Gate opens. Echoing. Hello. Anybody here? Rustling. Hello. Screams. Ticking. Clock squeaking. Continues ticking. Whoa. Gasps. Time groans. Stupid me-shaped corridor. Bell tolls. Time size. Will this day never end? It clings to me like a pair of sweaty pantaloons. Gasps. Who has stopped? Who has ticked? Their last talk. Talked. Their last tick. Size. Ah. William Hinkle. Heart beating. William Hinkle. Your time is up. Groans. Gasps. Gasps. Let's put you away, Mr. Hinkle. In the right place. Like alphabetical order. Muttering. Ah. Higgins. High bottom. Not here yet. High turn. High view. MLB. Ah. Hinkle. I hope you were happy. I hope you used your time well. Good night. Gate creaks. Gasps. Who is there? I saw you. How did you get in? It levels with intolerances. That's one hell of a strong ionosphere. Ferris. On radio. Yeah. I see it. Hey. You ever done a lander drop before? Fuck you. Laughs. Bricks. Ferris. Looks like a plasma storm. Is in the thermosphere. We got something like 250 kilometers per hour. It's gonna be a motherfucker to fly through. Upward. Yeah. I'm afraid so. Communications will be spotty if the storm goes electromagnetic. Or I'm gonna be safe to land. Depends on what you call safe. Bricks. T-20 seconds. Or I'm let's let her rip. All right, Paris, preparing for orbital mode. Over signal position now. Mother, please coordinate launch sequence. Mother, understood. You are clear to launch, Lander 1. All right, here we go. Launching, all, together, 3, 2, 1. Mother, Lander 1 released, Tennessee, and away they go. Upworth, looking gorgeous from up here. Paris, it's a good thing you're driving, and not the old man. Hey, a little less of the old man. Sweet tits. Paris, hey, language, language. Be respectful, there, sugar dick. I can hear you. Tennessee, she started it, laughing. Rix can talk about your tits if he wants. I'm very secure in our relationship. I'm good with my wife's tits. Continues laughing. Let's maintain focus. Upward, everything looking good down there. Paris, yeah, we're good. Expect to hit exosphere in 5. Might want to hold on back there. It's about to get rough. Mother announcing indistinctly. I hate space. Alum blaring. Laughs. This is why you need to do yoga. All exclaiming. Orum, hold it. Paris. Paris, I got it. Mother, recommend mission abort. Paris. Rix, Lander 1. We have Ratty COMM. Do you copy? Hey, what are you doing there? Grunts. Screams. Grunting. Alita couldn't get out of the way fast enough. Her mother, Chiron, couldn't deal with Alita's death. Maybe she just couldn't deal with me. So I went hunting. I needed to kill him. Maybe I was just hoping that he would kill me. It brought no peace. There were other demons like him out there, and I felt, somehow, I was responsible for all of them. So I registered as a hunter warrior. There's nothing noble about it. Did you ever find peace? I found you. Tammy, on my mother's blip life. If you're playing me, I swear I'll kick your ass. Probst, at Meramu, the little tribe of four was a huge underdog. Heavenly Father, we're very grateful for this wonderful day that we have ahead of us, and we ask thee if thou would please help us find all the things that we need to today, that we may be able to work hard together as team. I think we all have a spirit, and it's here. This is our time now. Probst, Gina was correct. It was their time. At the reward challenge, the tiny Meramu tribe emerged victorious. Hurry, hurry. Oh my god, oh my god. Probst, Meramu. Meramu won the opportunity to get back into the game. Their reward, a 2-minute raid of Rotu's camp. Go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Raid is over. Forgot this. Should have taken the frying pan. Probst, by day 14, Don wasn't certain he had the votes to oust Gabe and went to Sean to secure his vote. I need at least one of the other new members so I didn't get myself caught in a tie in case Gabe figured out that I was trying to vote him out. Planning to vote Gabe tomorrow, but I did want to know that if we lose that, you're not going home. Okay, okay, but you have to be tight. You have to keep your mouth quiet. I think it was a mistake that John told me that if they're going to vote for Gabriel, they needed to just do it and let me sit there and think that I was going to be next. All I'm saying is, stay tuned. Probst, the immunity challenge required the tribes to build an SOS signal. Put one in each corner. Even though it looks like Fat Albert and the Cosby Kids SOS sign, it's still, I think it's pretty good, considering what we have. I made him wear a hat today, because he looks like a pilgrim boy. Look at him. Alright, guys, this is it. Probst, the little mouse tribe of Meramu roared again by waving the American flag as part of their distress. Signal, blow your horn. Probst, Meramu finally won immunity. Horn blowing. Alright, cheering. Yeah, cheering. Probst, knowing that Gabe was the target of Roto's alliance, Rob approached Gabe in the hopes of having him vote against John. My only question I have for you is, if you were 100% set in the way you wanted to play the game, definitely a twist the way we shake things out. Rob Mariano was explaining that it was probably going to be me voted out tonight. Rob wanted to know if I would make an alliance with him and Sean and V and change the tide. Probst, but in the end, Gabe was true to his word. He wasn't there to play the game. He was only there for the experience, and everyone else was there to play the game, and Gabe was voted out. It's time for you to go. On day 16, Meramu was one happy little family. I feel stupid that we can't catch a fish. Oh look, I love it. Kathy and I were talking about how I want to go back to grad school and, you know, do some things, and how she's going back to school, and we talked about my dream job. What's your dream job? My dream job is to have a cabin restaurant, like a made out, like a log cabin restaurant in Alaska. Gina, she's so aspiring for dreams. She's bone honest, sweet, hardworking, incredible work ethic, and driven. I would come out and greet everybody and give them free coffee. Gina, I think it's a great idea. Every once in a while maybe, I'd make some homemade biscuits.
All you need to join is your membership fee. Let's see, that's $4,000.
This is gonna be cool.
Watch it!
Shut up, Beavis.
Oh, yeah.
Are you two new here? You look lost. The layout is simple. The pool and the jacuzzi are over there. Tennis courts are that way. Snack bar and lockers over that way. If you need anything, just ask for me, Donna.
Who's up for volleyball? Marco! Marco!
Hey, butthead, did you see that?
Yeah. Come to butthead.
Whoa, check it out. That's the same cat from that Janet Jackson video.
You're looking at the cat? How old are you, Beavis? Someday, Beavis, you're gonna have urges like me.
Shut up, buddy. I take out the chick, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
brains and chick. That's more like it.
Yeah.
Flats are cool. Hey, Beavis, have you ever drank a beer?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Where'd you get it?
The guy gave it to me.
You haven't drank a beer, lying wuss. I should, like, join this band.
Yeah. These chicks will talk to us.
They talk to me. Then they tell you to get your sorry ass out of there.
Yeah. Rock and roll is cool.
Whoa!
Are you in the band? You look good! Hey, fuck out of a
bar! Beavis and Butthead, you've lived long and fruitful lives. Now, what would you say is your crowning achievement?
We saw naked people.
Yeah.
I'm not your daughter. I don't know what I am. I do. Have a look at your original cyber core typing. This is your brain. A normal healthy teenage girl's brain, if there is such a thing. But this is your heart. Part of your original core, powered by an antimatter microreactor. So I've got a strong heart. Chuckles. You have a heart strong enough to power all of Iron City for years. This is lost technology. Nobody's made this stuff since before the fall. Chuckles. Yeah, right. So I'm 300 years old. Sweetheart, you are. I don't want my players losing unless I tell them to. It can't be left to chance. You promised me champions. And you promised me the best of everything. Get those military servos I asked for. You don't have a winning attitude. Just be ready for tomorrow's game. Muffled thumping. Grushka groaning. Grushka, help me. Chiron, Grushka, why should I waste my talent on you? Look what she's done to me. Ito's little cyber girl. What did you say? Alita, a woman in my memory called me 99. Ito, what you saw was a flash of your grunts. What? Low growling. Growling chuckle. Imitate siren wailing. Ah, again. Imitates horn honking. Bird 1, let's get down to the beach. Bird 2, follow the trail. Bird 3, last one there is a rotten eggy. What? Ship horn blowing. Huh. Didn't mean to photobomb you. Sorry about that. Rumbles. What is that thing? It looks like a UFO, an unidentified floating object. Daddy, stop it. No, I'm not your daddy. Giggling. Bird 1, what is that? Bird 2, look at the size of that thing. Surely, where's it going? Brad, I don't know, but it's not stopping. Alarm blaring. My house, alarm blaring, slow down, stop, panting, ah, freaking, phew, what the, groans, that house took me 5 years to build, wow, it's such a shame when you create something and someone just destroys it, Leonard on speaker, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very special guest for you, huh, he's a green marine sailing machine, careful, now, and he's keen to let you know he's not mean, put your wings together for Leonard, all gasping, thank you so much, please hold your applause, greetings from my world, the world of the pigs, whispers, what's a pig, I am a pig, size, gears clank, unbelievable, unbelievable, beeping, chuckles, oh, where are we going, wrong way, grunts, oh, oopsie, not working, size, we practiced this 100 times, Ross, oh, man, squeals, give it to me, oh, we're gonna come in again. I'm so sorry. Giggling. My name is Leonard. Screaming. But my friends call me Chuckles. Oh ho ho ho. Very generous. Thank. We mean no harm. Grunting. We saw your island across the sea. And we thought. Wonder what they're up to. But there's no other place besides here. Yes. There is. Stop it. And we are from there. Grunts. Please stop. We call it Piggy Island. Screams. Oh my god. P-I-G-G-Y Island. Screaming. Who else is out there? My first officer. Ross. And I have sailed everywhere. One brave soul against the sea. Panting. And Ross. Red. Excuse me. Have you come to smash all of our houses or just mine? Oh man. Crowd murmurs. Leonard. Somebody want a gift basket? Please. Please. Don't be afraid. All sigh. My partner and I request the honor of your friendship. Ross. Show em how we do it. Oh, chuckles. Don't worry, he's had all his shots. Shrieks. We're all friends now. Runs. Hi, friends. Low growling. Snorts. Come on. He's not breathing. Move. Let me help. Arthur. Come on. Pops. Coughing. Come on. Tom exhales. Arthur sighs in relief. I don't even know your name. It's Princess Ymera Z. Belichola. You may call me Mera. Thank you, Mera. Arthur grunts. Siren blaring. Dear God, this was ORM's doing. The worst is yet to come. Reporter 1, there's a flash flood warning here. That was just extended for a couple hours. Reporter 2, unprecedented sights from all over the world today. We are seeing warships and trash washed up by massive waves. Reporter 3, these extraordinary scenes of coastlines deluged with waves and garbage are taking place all over the world. Reporter 2, decades of pollution has been thrown back onto land. Reporter 4, many are asking the question, was this a natural disaster or something else? No, this was no natural disaster. They threw out our garbage and our warships. This was our first contact with the people of Atlantis. There you go again with your insane Atlantean theory. You have absolutely no proof. Dr. Shin, open your eyes. We already have an Atlantean living among us, and his name is Aquaman. Mera, what is it? This is the exact spot that Fuko gave me my first swimming lesson. Fuko, you have to forget all the teaching of the surface world and go deeper to uncover your Atlantean instincts. But I already know how to swim. Not even close. Arthur, just so we're clear, I'll help you stop this war, but then, I'm done. Maybe that's for the best. The ocean is more than our life source. Arthur, it is who we are. Wait, you can talk underwater? I can talk underwater too. This is leave my people. I will not. He's hunting us. He's targeting our family. You cannot ask this. The children, everything they've ever known. The forest. This is our home. He had our children. He had M under his knife. Size. My father gave me this vow as he lay dying. Voice cracking. And he said, protect the people. You're Torek Magdo. Jake, this will protect the people. Quaritch has spider. And that kid knows everything. He knows our whole operation. And he can lead them right in here. If the people harbor us, they will die. Do you understand? Look, I got nothing. I got no plan. But I can protect this family. That I can do. Size. Solemn music playing. I know one thing, Cross, wherever we go, this family is our fortress. Breathe shakily, sighs heavily, machine whirring, General Ardmore, where is Jake Sully? I don't know, groaning, we know that you know, Spider, I don't know, just form a picture in your mind, is it one of the floating mountains? Spider, let me out of here, he's fighting us, give us a minute, Spider, I don't know, just form a thought, and we will see it, Spider, I don't know, General Ardmore, look, I don't like this, any more than you do, Spider yells in pain, which clans would be harboring him, I don't know, you're gonna have to kill me, Spider screams, watch this, you're peeking all over the prefrontal, it's not gonna stop until you give us something, where is he, screaming, I don't know, you buttholes, voice cracks, okay, I don't know, yelling in pain, Spider panting, General, let me try the personal angle, he's not your son, shuddering, breathing heavily through mask, door closes, Quaritch grunts, whoa, 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 easy, Tiger, easy, grunts, snarls, we good, sighs, kid, you got hard, those science pukes leaned on you pretty hard, but you gave them nothing, exhales, I respect that, metal clinks, I thought you might want this, that's Colonel Miles Quaritch, deceased, killed in action, locket clatters, I'm not that man, but I do have his memories, enough to know that, well, he wasn't always the best father, but that's not an apology, I'm not your father, technically, you and I, we're nothing to each other, but, I can help you, I can get you out of here, I'm not gonna ask you to betray Jake Sully, I know you'd never do that, you're loyal, and I admire loyalty, just ride along, otherwise, I gotta give you back to the lab coats, wistful music playing, Jake, this is like stones in my heart, Tarsem is wise for his years, he will be a strong Oloe 10, the leader must not, yells, Tarsem grunts, so the leader can be born, Torek Magdo will disappear, people sobbing, the people will be safe, sighs heavily, wistful music continues, yips, yelps, Jake, a father protects, it's what gives him meaning, one life ends, another begins, music swelling, thunder rumbling, Ikran screeches, sighs tuck, Ikran screeches, Jake, the sea clans are a world unto themselves, Ikran trills, thousands of islands, an unknown territory, into which we could just vanish without a trace, are we there yet, captivating music playing, people yipping, people chattering, blissful music playing, Lupin, I want you to be there now, though, you could do it, you could make it happen, she was saying I got to do it, now, you know, you got to do your dream job now or it won't happen, when you hear somebody that's got that much energy for an idea, you should implement it now, you can always go back to school, I just don't have the money, it would be great to have her, find her dream, then you can help out with the wildlife area, that would be awesome, you should do it, it was relaxing for me, felt like I was talking to a really good friend about what I wanted to do with my life, Probst, at the start of the, wanted to do with my life, Probst, at the start of the reward challenge, Meramu was astonished to discover that Gabe had been voted out, they voted Gabe off, Probst, survivors ready, go, come on, Rob, stop, 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 Probst, you're still in this, let's go, come on, you guys, good job, come on, guys, okay, sharp, 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 come on, Probst, against all odds, the tiny tribe beat Rotu yet again, Meramu wins, feast, yeah, Probst, and sat down to a picnic lunch, oh my god, it's a picnic, I love picnics, Probst, on day 17, the stress of losing 3 challenges in a row reached a boiling point, and Rob Mariano called attention to the Rotu alliance, you, the general, Tammy and John, you guys don't have an alliance, the four of you, we have a friendship, not an alliance, that's interesting, I knew she was lying the second, she told it to me, I could just tell, you're telling me straight up that you four don't have an alliance, you four over here, how could you say that we don't, I mean, you'd have to be blind not to see that, Zoe just told me straight up in my face not even 5 minutes ago, John, maybe she's not thinking that way, hey, have I, you so far, John, do I have stupid, written on my forehead, if there's a traditional, merge and we all merge today, 3 of them and 7 of us, those 3 go first, that is my absolute word, Probst, John, Rob, and Sean agreed that if the tribes merged, they would vote out the members of Meramu first, don't try to, blip me, I won't, I promise, I'm taking your word, I will, okay, same thing, buddy, I think to a degree I may have convinced him that I'm part of the team now, I want him to trust me, but he shouldn't, Probst, but Rob still felt his neck was on the line going, into the next immunity, this immunity challenge is critical to me, if we don't win this challenge, then I'm probably gone tomorrow, Probst, survivors ready, go, Rob stepped up, took charge of the Rotu tribe, and came up with a huge victory, Rotu wins, this is it, that's what it's all about here, Probst, on day 18, the family of Meramu had to face their toughest decision, but in the end, old tribal lines held fast, Gina, I'm taking you to Alaska and I'm going to get that restaurant for you, Probst, and Gina was the 6th person voted off the island, Gina, the tribe has spoken, mail call, Probst, on day 19, 3 mail instructed both tribes to send one member on a journey, Kathy and Rob met at an ancient pipi, where they were told that the two tribes were being merged into one, tonight the new tribe will be born under your guidance, they celebrated with pizza and beer, but the partying soon turned to
life is cool.
These guys seem pretty cool.
Yeah.
I wanna make every woman I see. I wanna make every woman I see.
You sound like the woman at the drink out of the bar who's on you guys. That's the down next to me. Yeah, we're going, man.
Yeah. And then they kick your ass.
Shut up, buddy. I can take you guys.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Shut up, buddy.
I'm a hairy old sexual man. It's just a problem with my plans.
I could be wrong, but I think I saw him make a chick.
Really? You mean on the TV?
No, butt munch. In the TV.
You mean like inside, like where the tubes are and stuff?
What's your problem, Beavis? Okay, look at the TV. You see those guys?
Yeah, yeah.
That's where I saw the naked chick.
Well, that's just a bunch of guys.
Damn it, Beavis. Are you stupid?
Yeah.
Every cake in the oven, so sweet and delicious. Got a cake in the oven, we love to be shaped.
cool.
Fire, 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 fire.
Don't Bogart my log, dude.
Well, why did you enlist if you didn't want your breast fondled?
Ahoy, weather fans! Captain Dick Jackman here, the new center weather console. My trusty radar tells me there's a line of tornadoes forming in the Western County region. I'll have devastation footage at 6, plus the preschooler of the week.
Whoa. We're there, dude.
Yeah. Where?
The trailer park, dumbass.
Oh, yeah. Tornadoes are cool.
Yes. Now it's getting somewhere.
Yeah, yeah. Now we're getting somewhere.
Even the old dude is cool.
Yeah, yeah.
I like the tornado.
Yeah, yeah. Almost everything in this video is cool.
What do you mean, almost? What else do you want?
Well, it'd be pretty cool, like, if somebody puked.
Oh, let it be done. Check it out, Beavis. You asked for it, dude.
Yeah, but I didn't ask for blood. That would be on the limits of good taste. Tornadoes are cool. They can drive matches through a 2x4.
Yeah. A tornado could smash a poodle's face with a brick.
Yeah, you could suck a man's heart out of a chest.
Laughs, fuck no, no. Have you seen my kid? He's like 9 feet tall, and all he cares about is baseball. Do you go to all of his games? No, no, I don't. Amy laughs. The last game I went to was 6 hours long, and the final score was 1-2, so I'd rather go to Afghanistan than another kid's baseball game. Cheers. How do you think that your divorce affected your kid? How are things in your home, Amy? Oh, it's fine. Scoffs. Everything's fine. Ugh. I caught Mike having an affair online with a woman, and I guess it's been going on for like 10 months. Oh, did you drive a spike through his nuts? Laughing. No, here's the truth. Our marriage has been over for years. I don't even remember the last time we had sex. Kent and I have sex every Friday night after Blue Bloods. Laughs. I find Tom Selleck's work to be extremely erotic. I feel like everything that comes out of your mouth is a cry for help. Chuckles. Kiki, you're so weird. Carla, no, wait, why did you marry this shithead in the first place? He sounds like an asshole. Because we were young and in love. I mean, he wasn't always an asshole. I promise you, it's true. Listen, I got pregnant, we got married, I was only 20. You know what, Mike and I never got our 20s, like, you know, the fun 20s, and, feel, maybe he missed that. Oh my god, maybe I did, too. When I was in my 20s, I would just walk down the street, and it would just be raining dicks wherever I went. It was just dick, 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 dick. It was, like, forecast, lot of cock, indistinct, Kiki, ha, Kent, ha, what are you doing here? I'm just having lunch with my new friends. Who's watching the kids? Rosie, isn't that your job? Whoa, who the fuck are you? Yes, yes, Kent, it absolutely is my job, and I was just about to leave, so, thank you guys so much. I can percent do the math right now. Just take that and have a wonderful day, you guys. I really enjoyed it. Thank you. Oh, my, nice to meet you, Ike Turner. That's really disturbing. Yes, but on the plus side, she left way too much cash, so I think I'm gonna get fucked up. Rones. Yeah, donut holes. I love these things. How much are they? 5 cents. How about $1? Gasps. What? Hey now, big spender. Both chuckle. Thank you. MMM. Why are these so good? Caramel number 6. Is that what it is? MMM. They're tasty. She's adorable. Thank you. MMM. Good to see you. Bye bye. Oh my, oh my, oh my. What do we have here? Are these store-bought donut holes? Amy, what? No. Gosh, no. I'm an Asian and call it deterrence. You won't fool a fly or me. I'm not gonna drink it. You don't think dad would mind, do you? If I change just one thing in this room, because that should be upside down. We know better now, don't we? The devils don't come from hell beneath us. No, no. They come from the sky. Blood dripping. Bats screeching. Breathing shakily. Sighs. Oh, I hope the next generation of Waynes won't inherit an empty wine cellar. Quietly. Not that there's likely to be a next generation. Thank you, sir. Alfred sighs. This is every call made from the Russian's phone. Two mentions of business with the white Portuguese, and it's continually transmitting blacked out data to the personal residence of Alexander Luthor. You think Lex Luthor is the white Portuguese? Sniffs. I can't see that he needs the income from imported arms. Regardless, I'll need to put a leech at his house, and I'm gonna need the suit. The bat interrogated 6 people and came away with nothing. It was Bruce Wayne that got the information. Well, Bruce Wayne can't break into Lex Luthor's house. Bruce Wayne won't have to. He's been invited. Reporters clamoring. Camera clicking. Who's that? You must be new to the Let Them Eat Cake beat. That is Bruce Wayne. LeBlanc, philanthropist, bibliophile, true friend of the Library of Metropolis. Mr. Lex Luthor. All applauding. Me. Okay, Nikki. You're embarrassing me. Speech. Blah, blah, blah. Open bar. Clears throat. The end. Chuckles. Guests laughing. The word philanthropist comes from the Greek, meaning a lover of humanity. It was coined about 2,500 years ago. Alright, where am I going? Alfred, go past the elevator. Do a left. That's right. Must be. It's in the service corridor in the basement. Go down the stairs. Lex, gods and men. Prometheus went with us, and he ruined Zeus' plan to destroy mankind, and for that he was given a thunderbolt. Imitates thunderbolt zapping. That seems unfair. On a serious note, the Library of Metropolis. Go to the stairs. You saw them on your way in. Down the stairs. Lex, but at one time, dad could not buy them. No, my father could not afford books growing up. He had to root through the garbage for yesterday's motorcycle, which you stole. Scoffs. I didn't steal that. I commandeered it. Okay, because it was faster and and clearly had insurance. And by the way, the lady that I saved, she didn't seem to mind. Let me tell you something, man, the rescues don't mean a thing if you put other people in danger. Okay, now, I get it, you're fast, you're fearless, and I have to make you a trainee, butterfly, but you got a lot to learn. Alright, thank you, Lieutenant. Click's tongue. Alright, listen up, training begins at 0600, Hot Wheels, I'll see you back here in the morning. Sure thing, Lieutenant. Welcome to Baywatch, Ronnie cheering. Alright, Victoria, hey, I'm so glad I caught you all. I don't mean to interrupt, but everyone on the beach is talking about you guys. Thank you, Brody, that save sounds incredible. Impulsive, but incredible. Appreciate it. See that? We're just doing our jobs. Oh, hey, guys, this is Victoria Leeds, the new owner of the Huntley Club. Hey, how you doing? Hey, well, I just wanted to invite all of you to the Huntley. We're having an open house. It's a kind of a meet the neighbors thing. Look, I know that the club's kind of fancy, and probably not your scene, but you have a standing invitation. Thank you. We'll keep that in mind. I'll see you there. See you then. Let's go. Ranking. Engine starts. Size. CJ. Brody. Hey, what are you doing? Nothing. I was just, you know, stargazing. Under a pier? Yeah, that way. Look, you're on the team. And, I don't want anyone on the team sleeping outside. So, yeah, come on. You're coming with me. Let's go. Brody, let's go. I don't want to wait for you. Come on. Brody, thank you again, so much. Really embarrassed. CJ. Yeah, no, it's totally cool. Don't worry about it. Oh, I forgot something in my car. Just knock. You sure Stephanie won't mind? It's cool, it's cool. She won't mind at all. Thank you so much. This is really cool of you guys. No problem. Gasps. What the fuck's up? Hey, this is your house, isn't it? Yeah, this is, it's my house. Yeah, chuckles. I assume you need a place to crash. Yeah, come on in. Just like CJ, always picking up strays. Sus. Quit looking at little Mitch. It's creepy. Come and see where you're gonna crash. There's your cot. Don't jack off on my sheets. Don't. Man 1, on radio. I can't find my hermit crab. I think he ran out earlier today. He's got short legs, but he's got a fast walk, so if you'd keep eyes open, I'd appreciate that. Man 2, on radio. I will start combing the beach first thing at sunup. Man 3, this is Echo Bravo 153. Go ahead. Fuck it. Mitch, can I please turn the CB off in my room? Mitch, on radio. Jonas, brother, listen to me. Get your beauty rest. We're starting bright and early tomorrow. Groans. Upbeat music playing. How was your first riptide? Groaning. It's prodigal serial number returns. A 30-year-old open case finally closed. Thank you, officer. I'm here for Mr. Wallace. I'm love. He named you. Must be special. I'm here for Mr. Wallace. Follow me. Love. The ancient models give the entire endeavor a bad name. What a gift, don't you think? From Mr. Wallace to the world. The outer colonies would never have flourished had he not bought Tyrell. Revivified the technology. To say the least of what we do. Classical music plays. I see you're also... More important conversation. Zoe and I were like the moms. You know, we're cleaning up. Really? Oh, yeah. You and Zoe feel you're pretty close. Zoe and I were like moms. Let's clean the place up. Unreal. Yeah, it's unreal. The lies going on. She told me that she was voting you off. What exactly did Gina say about me that made me out to be such a bad person that they want to vote me off so bad now? You're a lazy bum and you don't care about anything. Really? Robst, with this new information, Kathy and Rob felt vulnerable. They decided they would never vote against each other. Do you want to make a pact? Me and you. Do you want to? They'll never know. It will be just me and you. Alright. Alright, let's do it. Robst. The next morning, Kathy and Rob awoke for breakfast. This morning was amazing. Not only was it just being on that pillow so wonderful, and having soft cushions under my body, when I woke up I saw a tray of food. I just felt it was a dream. I truly did. This is out of control. They're donuts, pastries. Well, to the new tribe, new beginning. Yes, we really pounded out a name for our new tribe. Soli Antu. We took the sun, and we took the word alliance, and we took the word sacred, and we wanted to use those three words, and then we also wanted a word that we can shout out when we win, and it sounds good. Soli Antu, sacred alliance of sun and fire. That looks pretty cool. You know that? Yeah, it does. Teamwork. Kathy was awesome company. We named the new tribe, painted a new flag, and we got everything done we needed to get done. I just had a wonderful time. What a wonderful, wonderful night. Props. They returned to Meramu, where they told Nelly and Pascal they had 5 minutes to load their supplies onto their raft. We got 5 minutes. We got to get everything we got on the raft. Everything. Come on, everything we got. Everything. Get the kettle. Get the knives. Nelly, touch the raft. You did it. There were only 4 of us and we did it. We're a team. All of us. There's a merge. No, there's a merge. Oh, really? We have so much to talk about. Here you go, man. Okay, so this is our new buff. This is it. Here. Props. Greeted by the members of Rotu, Rob handed out the new buffs and displayed the new flag. What's the new name, guys? Cool. Soli Antu. And that name means, I can't remember. I keep forgetting. It has all of our initials. Sacred allegiance to the sun. Sacred allegiance to the sun. Good job. Yeah. Soli Antu. 1, 2, 3. Soli Antu. Props. But the good cheer and camaraderie at Soli Antu disappeared on day 21 when Rob confronted Zoe. Zoe, you didn't have an agreement about taking everybody from their side of the island off. You don't remember anything about that? No. See, this is what I mean. Unbelievable. And Kathy wasn't your first choice as soon as she got here? Tell the truth for once, will you? Tell the truth. Props. Kathy, disillusioned and angry, fled to the waterfall. Zoe's lying to me. They're all lying to me. They're all lying to me and I'm being played as a pawn. A pawn. I need the immunity because I'm...
Show it to him before he dies.
Yeah. They could, like, pick up a phone booth and move it 5 miles away and then put it back without tracking it. Hey, Steven, check out that trailer.
Hi, I'm Alita, and this is Tank Ray.
Is Ro about to die? We were wondering if you guys like your last boyfriends on Earth.
Okay.
Great. Let those guys in.
I'm getting a Woodrow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, baby. What? You mean I was gonna do it?
You're just gonna spank your muscles.
You wish, you'll weep.
Cool too. But I don't know, it's like, here, it just like, it falls flat.
Yeah, yeah. I think even if they had some fire in this video, it would still suck.
Check it out. It's Crocus coming to kick their ass.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the night of the living bands that suck.
Hey, Butthead, you think those two chicks are alive?
Of course not, Ass Munch. They would have tried to find us by now.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Lolita, and this is Tank Ray.
A couple of skis may be trying to follow us. Can we stay with you guys for a while?
Whoa. She's one of those.
Customer, are you satisfied with our product? She's very realistic. Thank you. Here, all the junk is in here. Lucky for you, Mr. Wallace is a data hoarder. Scanner whirring. No one's been down here in ages. Sorry about that. All our memory bearings from the time. They were all damaged in the blackout, but there are sometimes fragments. Deckard on monitor. You got a little boy. He shows you his butterfly collection, plus the killing jar. Rachel, I take him to the doctor. Deckard, there's a wasp crawling on your arm. Rachel, I kill it. Deckard, you're reading a magazine. You come across a full-page nude photo of a girl. Rachel, is this testing whether I'm a replicant or a lesbian? Mr. Deckard. Deckard, just answer the questions, please. Static crackling on monitor then stops. It was unclear where this whole town apart. Take a knife and cut this pain from my heart. I didn't know music could be like that. I mean, is a dream a lie if it don't come true? Or is it something worse? Congratulations. You popped your bruised cherry. You never forget your first time. Jobit exhales. Typing. Door opens. I wrote something. Did I ask you to write something? I had to write it. It's about music. A record review. Sort of. Can you read it? Alan, it's a town full of losers. And I'm pulling out of here to win. Thunder Road. Springsteen. No one listens to Springsteen anymore. He's history. Typing. Can you just read it, please? Rock music playing. Springsteen singing. Miss Clay Jobit, I'm really disappointed in you. You hated my poems. I hated that you threw them away. Before anyone ever read them. You read them. Every one of them. Even Luton is a four-letter word. Miss Clay, yeah. And I can think of several more four-letter words for Luton too, but the point is they're raw, they're distinctive. You have a responsibility to make this invisible, this absent voice heard. But you're my teacher, miss. Do you really think anyone else would be interested? I'm interested. See, stop doubting. Keep writing. My dad doesn't even know I'm doing English. He thinks I'm doing economics. This is about what you want. You have a gift, Javid. You could be a writer if you put the work in. Really, me. Bruce Springsteen is not some romantic faraway figure who sings about romantic faraway things. He's a local boy, and the things he deals in are things they recognize only too well. Man one, well, he's one of us, you know. Man two, he's part of New Jersey. Man three, we call him the boss, and he is the boss. There was an exuberance, let's say, about something like Born to Run. Reporter, the songwriter seems to have become more concerned with rather bleak matters. Springsteen lately, I guess, mainly I've just tried to scale it down to what I feel. Chuckles, life sizes, you know. My sister, she got married when she wrote her song. Ryan, is it strong enough? That's all I'm asking. If I'm on my own here, then I apologize. How does your new song go, then? You call me sweet like I'm some kind of cheese. It's good. Wow, is that, you know, when my hand's on your grease gun. That's very subtle, isn't it? It's a metaphor. Ryan, it's just a bit weird. Roger, what exactly are you doing with that car? Ready, children, please. We could all murder each other, but then who would be left to record this album? Statistically speaking, most bands don't fail, they break up. Ready, why the hell would you say something like that? Roger, there's only room in this band for one hysterical queen. Brian, you know why you're angry. Roger, Roger, what? Cause you know your song isn't strong enough. John, not, is that strong enough? What about that? Brian and John, not the coffee machine. Hashtag goodbye, everybody, I've got to go. Hashtag, hashtag gotta leave you all behind and face the truth. Hashtag, hashtag mama, oh hashtag, hashtag I don't wanna die. Hashtag, hashtag I sometimes wish I'd never been born at all. Hashtag, exhales and chuckles, inhales deeply. Music stops. Brian, what next? That was pretty damn good. Brilliant, I love that. Brian, press the button. Freddy, I know where it is. I know where, knock, knock, good. Freddy, it's good. You know, play it like you you wrote it. Well, I did. I wrote that part. Taking a piss. Brian, okay. Are you happy? I think it's beautiful. It's almost perfect. Brian, almost. Yes, give it more rock and roll. I'm always up for that. Fred, ready. Put your body into it. Right. Okay, put my body into it. I got it. Not like that. No, I got it. I got it. Bit more soul. Yeah, alright. Give it more heart. I'll do that. We good to go. Roy, you good? Oh, and then there's the operatic section. You're gonna love it. The operatic section. I know. It sounds crazy. I love it, Fred. I love it. I don't know. It could be a flop. It could work. I love it. Chuckles. What have we got to lose? Chuckles, nothing. If you say so. Okay, let's go. Deassy. Recorded music playing. Singing Bohemian Rhapsody. Roger, how was that? John, Freddy, higher. Can you go a bit higher? If I go any higher, only dogs will hear me. Trot. Freddy's note. Sorry. Roger. Oh, go on. Roll the tape. Overdub 24 of Fred's thing. Singing Bohemian Rhapsody. How was that? Better. Higher. Jesus. How many more Galileos do you want? Freddy wants to do a few more overdubs. Do we even have any tape left? I do have to say the tape is wearing out. It can't take much more. Yeah, we can't afford much more. We're already 3 weeks over schedule. Dub 26 of Fred's thing. One more. One more. Freddy. One more. Again. Roger. Go on. Roll the track. Who even is Gal? Getting the axe. I don't know. It's just not adding up, but I'm going to trust what Rob told me, and I need immunity to stay in the game. Robst, survivors ready? Go. Outbalancing the others on an unsteady platform in the rough. Serve Kathy one immunity. Kathy wins immunity. You want this? Yeah. Robst, come get it. Alright, baby. Robst, turn around here. Cheering. Yes. Back at solely unto. Rob accused John of backing out on his word. What happened about my word? Is my bond? Oh, yeah. Mine was like fine. But as soon as you double tracked and circled back end, came up with other ideas and it's like I'm done. Robst, but John accused Rob of breaking their agreement when Rob spoke to Kathy. Don't tell me one thing and just because I think about something or just because I talk to somebody, then all of a sudden it's off. To be honest, I'm not going to have this conversation. I'm not going to decide for myself until we get there. Tonight, I thought we had an agreement. We did, until you went to Kathy and told her at the other side and said they're going to vote you out first. I did not say that. I'm not going to have this conversation. Don't lie to my face. There we go. Now it's on. Man, Robst, in the end, all the drama in camp brought about Rob's demise. Even Rob's former Meramu ally, Vesapia, wrote his name down at the voting booth. Rob, the tribe has spoken. Good luck, guys. Robst, the next day, Kathy confronted Zoe. There was never any intention of voting you off. No way in hell. We wanted to get Roto back together as a team. Zoe just lied to me point blank about the fact that the tribe had definitely scoped me out for the first vote off when we merged. Oh my god, love you guys. Robst, the tribe received materials to build kites for the next reward challenge. Too much wind. Oh, my kite is going to be a miserable failure. Oh, stop it. I'm serious. Oh, go fly a kite. Robst, so they did. Run, John, run. Competing for the chance to have a Snickers bar and then go scuba diving, the survivors attempted to fly their kites into the Marquesan sky, but it was Kathy who went the distance. Yeah, yeah, woo. Robst, underwater, Kathy experienced the serene world of Marquesan marine life. On land, things weren't as peaceful as Sean fought for his survival. I get frustrated because I feel like nobody is playing the game, and I feel like we've kind of succumbed and let the four people run the show. I'm telling you, I'm going to talk with Kathy. I totally agree with you. I think Tammy and John are playing a game and they're playing it so hard it's obnoxious. If you're in agreement, me, you and V are on the same wavelength. Yeah, we are, but we just need to get Pascal and Nelly. And you know what? I think we can do it, my boy. Robst, on day 24, the immunity challenge was a game of elimination, but Sean, Vesapia, and Kathy saw it as the alliance's arrogant display of the pecking order, showing who they would be voting out next. This is the order of how it's going to go. Way to go. I swear we could take them out. I swear we could. Robst, Tammy won immunity, and she, John, Zoe, and the general openly celebrated their victory. I almost was going to do you because I hated to get Pascal. Another time, it didn't seem to bother you that much. Robst, Nelly, and Pascal were also angered by the arrogant conduct the foursome had displayed during
Grubby Girl.
Yeah.
She wants me.
Yeah.
Why don't they show that?
No. Yeah. She said she just had sex.
It wasn't with any of those guys. If this video had some explosions, it would be the coolest video ever.
Yeah. And, like, the music was cool, too.
Oh, yeah. And they'd have to have some, like, better singing.
Yeah. And not those guys.
Yeah. Then it would rule.
Yeah, but it's now or it's a cheap on Family Tie.
Yeah, this is really noisy.
Yeah, it's noisy.
This chick is weird.
This chick's mouth is crooked.
I wonder why.
Yeah. Why is it crooked?
I don't know. The name of the song is 50 Foot Queenie.
Yeah, I'd like a 50 Foot Queenie.
I'd like a 50 Foot Queenie.
Yeah, yeah. That would be cool too.
And that's how supply and demand fuels our capitalist system. Now, in order to protect the common people...
I thought he was going to talk about how to get money.
Monsters,
yeah,
we have what's called the Federal Trade Commission. Now, capitalism isn't the only choice in our multicultural world. In Denmark, for example...
Were you talking about money?
Yeah. We have some?
Beavis, you have to work to acquire money. Don't you remember when I talked about the concept of work?
Uh... I guess it was, like, a long time ago.
Yeah. We forget.
Well, enough preaching. I think I'm going to introduce you boys to the rewards of manual labor.
There's a manual?
Reading sucks.
Damn it. I'm sick of seeing videos in school.
Yeah, really.
If I wanted to see a video in school, I'd go to school and watch TV.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
Whoa. That locker's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. What's this? This sucks.
Yeah.
Shut up. Heavy metal has come a long way.
Yeah. Really.
Cool. Chick.
Yeah. I mean, you know the chicks are cool. It's like the video still sucks.
Yeah. Really. This is disgusting, David.
Yeah. It's like it is.
Look at this guy.
Yeah.
Look at his face.
Yeah.
A woman groaning. A backup plan never hurts. Dash, Joe size. Joey, we didn't struggle giving you an education so you could be a middle-aged man washing your underwear in my shop, walking around with a hole in his pants. Yeah, but with this job you'll be able to put that dead-end gigging behind you. And Lord knows we need more teachers in this world. And just think, playing music will finally be your real career. So you're going to tell them yes, right? Please say yes. Yeah, definitely. Libba, good. Dash, Joe size. Dash, jazz music ringtone playing. Hello, how you been, Mr. G? It's Curly. Lamont Baker. Hey, Curly. Hey, good to hear your voice, man. Listen, you can call me Joe now, Curly. I'm not your teacher anymore, Curly. Oh, okay, Mr. Gardner. Hey, look, I'm the new drummer in the Dorothea Williams Quartet, and we're kicking off our tour with a show at the Half Note tonight. Dorothea Williams, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Congratulations, man. Wow, I would die a happy man if I could perform with Dorothea Williams, Curly. Oh, well, this could be your lucky day. Upbeat jazz music playing. Dash, tire screech. Dash, car horn blares. Saxophone playing. Curly, will you up? There he is. Hey, Curly. Leon Skipping Town really put us in a bind, man. Yeah, I'll bet. I'm glad you made it. My boy, Bishop, said he sat in with you on a set last year in Brooklyn. Said you were great. Chuckles. Well, you know, for a coffee shop. Saxophone playing improvised solo. Curly, hey, Dorothea, this is the cat I was telling you about. My old middle school band teacher, Mr. Gardner. Call me Joe, Dorothea. I mean, Miss Williams. It's a pleasure. Wow, this is amazing. Curly, Joe is Ray Gardner's son. So, we're down to middle school band teachers now. Get on up here, teach. We ain't got all day. Band plays cool jazz music. What are we playing? Dash, it's note on piano. Band continues playing. Plays corresponding notes haltingly. Playing corresponding chords. Playing improvised notes. Playing melodious trilling notes. Continues playing improvised trilling notes. Music ends. Sorry, I zoned out a little back there. Chuckles. Joe Gardner, where have you been? I've been, teaching middle school band. But on the weekends, you got a suit. Get a suit, teach. Good. No. Are you alright? I don't know what's going on. Talk to me, Sean. Look, I don't know who Sean is, and I don't know who you are. Okay, we'll get off at the next stop. We'll figure out whatever's going on here. Okay, this doesn't belong to me. Look at me. Everything's gonna be okay. Captain Coulter Stevens, this is Beleaguered Castle. Captain Coulter Stevens, this is Beleaguered Castle. Knowledge transmission. Captain Stevens, do you copy? Where am I? You're with Beleaguered Castle. Are you functional? I'm dizzy. Did I just a lock? Just in your rotation. Can you report at this time? What is this? What is this? Where am I talking to? Captain, report what you saw. What? I don't understand. Where were you before you were talking to me? There was an explosion coming from where? Some confusion is perfectly normal at this stage. Captain, do you have a visual signal? Who are you? You already have that information. Captain, I do. Recall my name. We'll rebuild the pattern. Try to focus. I was on a mission. I was flying, and then I woke up on a train, and now I'm here. I need to be brief. What unit is this? You're with Beleaguered Castle. Who? Stand by for thread one of alpha memory pattern. What is Beleaguered Castle? The exercises will assist you. Memory thread one. Listen to the following passage. Lily awoke in an evening dress and opera cloak. In her hand were five playing cards. Is this a joke? They were. Queen of spades. Four of clubs. Nine of clubs. You need new attractions. Right. New ones. Get it? Big shiny new things. Yeah, absolutely, sir. Look at me. Look at me and listen. The customer is always right. Screams. Oh, right. The customer is always right. You quiz. Exactly. Always. Groans. All right. Okay. We need something. N-A-W-T. My bad. We need something. Else. Nutty. Nutty. Something wacky. N-A-W-T. Wacky. We need something. 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 We need something. Looney. Oops. Looney. Thank you. Looney. I'm an L. Shoot me. Yes. Looney. Yes. Now you're talking. Looney. Looney. That's it. That's the word I was looking for. Looney. Get the Looney Tunes. Looney Tunes. Bring them here. Blanco. Sir. Just noticing. Sir. They're from Earth. What if they can't come? What did you say? What if they can't come? Make them. Cool. Make them. Ha ha ha. Creatures. We're gonna go get them. Yeah. All right. Empire. Strike. Looks good in that uniform. Looks great. Can't teach that. Can't teach it. Thanks for autographing that basketball for my kid. I'm a hero now. No problem. Happy to do it, man. Let's go. Curveball. Don't swing. Don't swing. Empire. Ball. Pass ball. Outside corner. Swing. Strike. Catcher. That was your pitch. I know. I missed it. Don't worry. I'll get you another one. Cadillac. Cadillac. Come here. Sorry. I didn't mean to. Come here. Yes, sir. Everybody got that. Good. When will the princess marry? In the hour. Sure. Well, I hope it's a long ceremony. Thus, it's gonna be a short honeymoon. Hot. Too hot. Oh, if only your mother were alive to see this day. Everyone ready? Yes, Her Majesty. No. Where's my droid of honor? Oh, dear. Yes. Where's dot matrix? Oh, thank God. Where have you been? Here I am. Sorry. I had to make a pit stop. I'm so excited. I couldn't hold my oil. All right, people. It's magic time. Right. Everyone starting Concentration on the left foot. Daddy, that's your right foot. It's too late. Keep going. Daddy, must I go through with this? I'm sorry, my dear. You have to, but Daddy, I don't love him. I'm sorry, Vespa. He's the last prince left in the galaxy. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here on this most joyous occasion to witness Princess Vespa, daughter of King Roland, going right past the altar, heading down the ramp and out the door. Stop her. Someone, stop her. Stop her. Hey, boy, you forgot to get married. Will you stop? What are you doing? No questions. Stop. Get in. Where is she going? Where is she going? Thumbbxck. Barf, 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 barf. Always when I'm eating. Barf. What can I do you for? Where you been? Grabbing a snack. Want some? No. Little hair of the dog. No. Listen, answer that for me. Will you watch that? Oh, sorry. I'll just throw on your audio. That way they won't see you. Why hello? Hello, Bone Star. Sorry. Wrong switch. Flowers. They're beautiful. And those are from Harry. Was he here tonight? Yeah. I ran into him outside. What's with you guys anyway? It's complicated. Tell me again. Was I really good? I was so nervous. My knees were shaking. Your knees were fine. The applause wasn't very loud. Yes, it was. Well, it's the acoustics. It's all about the fusion. It keeps the sound waves from grouping. You see, when the sound waves, they propagate and it's like an, you are such a nerd. Monitor beeping. Wow. Oh, did you see that one? You know what? I'd like to sing on stage for the rest of my life with you in the first row. I'll be there. Tell me you love me. I love you. I love you so much. I always have. Engine revs. Ready. Yep. Dispatcher speaking indistinctly over radio. Train rumbling nearby. Light switch clicks. You can't hide here, Flint. I'm just here to see my daughter. You are an escaped convict. The cops are looking for you. We're not getting near her. You're nothing but a common thief. You maybe even killed a man. It wasn't like that. It wasn't. I had good reason for what I was doing. And that's the truth. You and the truth. Sitting in prison, having three meals a day together. I live in the presence of great truth. And that is the truth that you left behind. Right there in that bedroom. Door creaks. Penny. I miss you. I miss you too. Penny. I promise I'll make you healthy again. Whatever it takes, I'll get the money. Emma, you get out of here. Now. Sirens wailing nearby. I'm not a bad person. Just had bad luck. Or bell rings. Peter, what is it? It's MJ. I'm gonna ask her to marry me. Oh. The challenge. There was a pecking order and we were included in it. Even though we were told that that wasn't true. Probst and decided to take matters into their own hands. I'm not going to go out fifth or sixth. We've worked too hard. Probst in the shelter. Vesapia apologized to Sean for siding with the Alliance and voting against Rob. They came to me 6 or 7 days after we were here and told me they wanted to be part of the fivesome. And I said if you do not lie to me, I will go five with you. And then once we get the five, it's every man for themselves. I just wish you had trusted your brother a little more. You saw what they did to me and Rob. I said these guys were exactly. If I've done wrong with you, I apologize. I'm saying this right here and now. Straight up, I apologize to you. Probst. With Vesapia on board, the fivesome decided somebody needed to be done. Today is the last day we will ever get a fair chance. After that, it's going to be four and four. It's going to be up for vote and it's just the way I feel, you guys, right now. And I'm being honest with you. Obviously, Pascal and Nelly started to see what I've been talking about all along, that the four horsemen have an alliance. They've been switching on and off, first with me and Rob, then with her and Pascal. So now the new agreement we have is myself and Nelly, V, Pascal, and Kathy are going to vote John out tonight. Probst. That night at Tribal Council, they struck back. The 8-person voted out the first member of our jury, John. You need to bring me your torch. The alliance of John, Tammy, Zoe, and the general was broken when John was voted out of the tribe. The tribe has spoken. It's time for you to go. Good night. John was the 8th person to go, but he will return as the first member of the jury, which will ultimately decide who will be the sole survivor. Over the next 15 days, the Soli Unto tribe will experience the culture and the game in ways unlike any survivors before them. Join us as the adventure continues. Stay tuned for scenes from our next episode. Probst. Next time on Survivor, John's departure marks a new era at Soli Unto. It's a new day we're starting. Here, friends become bitter enemies. From the get-go, I didn't like you. I have changed my opinion of Zoe. Zoe is a bitch. Probst. And too lucky. Survivors get away from it all. Now for the reward. An authentic Marquesan feast. Give me the radio right there. It's the wake-up show. It's the wake-up show. It's the wake-up show. It's the wake-up show. Raw. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning. Ding, ding, ding.
Mi casa. Well, guys, now's your chance to earn your daily bread.
Yeah, bread is cool.
Okay, here. And here you go. And don't forget these. And try to use the natural sponges, but not my prized loofah, of course. And, oh, yes, you'll find recycling bins out in the garage.
I don't get it.
He wants us to wear rubber gloves.
Yeah. Cool.
Oh, and one more thing. Try to be careful. In fact, make sure you don't touch my irreplaceable 8-track collection. Okay, guys, have fun. And remember to recycle.
Hey, Butthead, what are these things?
I don't know.
This one's broken.
Cool. Let's watch it.
Yeah.
It won't fit, Beavis.
It must fit somewhere. Maybe your butt. Hey, Butthead, what were we supposed to do again?
I think it said, don't touch, the house.
Weren't we supposed to, like, clean something?
Oh, yeah. The tapes.
Cool.
Hey, Butthead, I know a cool way to drive you. He's gonna pay us a lot of money for this.
Hello?
Hello, Butthead. Hey, guess what? I'm in the process of purchasing goods and services for the murder. Butthead, what's that noise?
It's a dirt buster.
Ah, great. I'm looking forward to seeing how you clean the house.
Clean the house. Okay. Bye. Is this circus music?
Yeah.
You said bone. Oh.
Yeah.
That's not bono anyway, dumbass.
Oh.
With you. How come English people are always whining?
Yeah.
No, it's lipstick. Oh. He's a lipstick-wearing, whining...
Peter, the day your Uncle Ben asked me to marry him, we were so scared and excited and very young, and I loved him. You have a plan? I don't have a plan. No, he's just gonna collect tiny spoons when we're traveling to other countries. Like a grandmother? I'm not collecting tiny spoons. He's collecting tiny spoons. Oh, okay, well, that was a real roller coaster. By the way, travel tip. You should download a VPN on your phone so the government can't track you while we're abroad. Smart, will do. School bell rings. Dude, I think that went really great. Woman, when I blipped back to my apartment, the family that was living there was very confused. The wife thought that I was a mistress. Grandma thought that I was a ghost. It was really a mess. Thank you for coming out to support those who have been displaced by the blip. And, of course, thanks to our very own Spider-Man, cheering, clears throat. Thank you, Miss Parker, for having me. And thank you, you guys, for having me. And thank you, Spider-Man. They'll be right back out to take photos and videos. Thank you, cheering. That was amazing. That was great. That was so cool. I was so nervous. I was a little stiff. I wasn't in the pocket. I thought you did great. You were a little stiff. Yeah, I felt that too. I felt that too. It's fine. It's fine. Okay. Did you get your passport? Yeah. Mini toothpaste? Yeah, I did. Clattering. Hey, sorry I'm late. Happy. Hey, oh, you look lovely. Thanks. You too. Thank you. New dress? Yeah. Yes, it is. It's a new beard. It's my blip beard. I grew it in the blip. It's a blip beard. I see. Yeah, the reason I'm late is because this was misplaced at the office. Can you believe it? Because it's enormous. Not the amount, the size. The amount's nice too. They're generous. Oh, haha. Pepper said, sorry she couldn't be here. Yeah, thank you. I think I'm gonna go change the sterno under the vegan lasagna. Spider-Man, go shake hands. Will do. What just happened? Heads up. Nick Fury's calling you. Fury's gonna call me. Yeah, what? He probably has hero stuff for you to do. You're a superhero. He calls superheroes. If it was that important, he'd probably call someone else. Not me. Cell phone buzzing. Apparently not. No caller ID. That's him. I don't want to talk to Fury. Answer the phone. What? If you don't talk to him, I have to, and I don't want to. Why not? Because I'm scared. Answer the phone. You sent Nick Fury to voicemail. Yeah, you don't send Fury to voicemail. Hear that? They're calling me. I got to go. You clattering. Pizza time. Ticking loudly. You're late. I'm not paying for those. Joe's 29-minute guarantee is a promise. And I know to you, Parker, a promise means nothing. To me, it's serious. It's serious to me too. Mr. Aziz, you're fired. Go. Please, I need this job. You're fired. Look, give me another chance. Jameson, you're fired. Parker, hello. You're fired. Peter, what? Dogs catching close bees. Pigeons in the park. A couple of geezers playing chess. Boss, not now. I was thinking maybe the Bugle could show another side of New York for a change. You got 6 minutes to deadline. Jonah, we need page one. Parker, I don't pay you to be a sensitive artiste. I pay you because still not now. I pay you because, for some reason, Psycho Spider-Man will pose for you. Spider-Man won't let me take any more pictures. He turned the whole city against him. A fact I'm very proud of. Now, get your pretty little portfolio off my desk before I go into a diabetic coma. Boss, your wife's on the line. She says she lost her checkbook. Thanks for the good news. Mr. Jameson, please, isn't there any of these shots you can use? I really need the money. Miss Brandt, get me a violin. Yes. 5 minutes to deadline. Jonah, alright, run a picture of a rancid chicken. Here's the headline. Food poisoning scares Sweet City. Some food got poisoned. I'm a little nauseous. Yeah. Alright, Mr. Jameson. It stinks. Robbie, here's your page one. Hey, man, what's up? Norman, Harry, won't you be needing this? Thanks, Dad. Peter, may I introduce my father, Norman Osborn. Peter, I've heard so much about you. Great honor to meet you, sir. Harry says you're a science whiz. You know, I'm something of a scientist myself. I read all your research on nanotechnology. Really brilliant. And you understood it? Yes, I wrote a paper on it. Impressive. Your parents must be very proud. I live with my aunt and uncle. They are proud. Teacher, hey, you too. Let's move. Nice to meet you. Hope to see you again. He doesn't seem so bad. Yeah, not if you're a genius. I think he wants to adopt you. Guide, there are over 32,000 known species of spider in the world. Guide, there are over 32,000 known species of spider in the world. They're in the order Araneae, divided into three suborders. Peter, top. That's amazing. This is the most advanced electron microscope on the eastern seaboard. It's unreal. Guide, arachnids from all three groups possess varying strengths which help them in their constant search for food. For example, the Delena spider, Amelie Sporacidae, has the ability to jump to catch its prey. For the school paper, camera clicks. Next, we have the net web spider, Amelie Philostatidae, genus Cuculcania. It spins an intricate funnel-shaped web whose strands have a tensile strength proportionately equal to the type of high-tension wires used in bridges. Leave him alone, or what? Or his father will fire your father. Guys laugh. What's daddy gonna do? Sue me? What is going on? The next person who talks will fail this course. I kid you not. Guide, the spider lets go. Once using a set of reflexes with nerve conduction velocity so fast that some researchers believe it borders on pre- precognition, and early awareness of danger. Those guys are jerks. A spider sense. Business is good. Can't you hear me knocking? Spider-Man theme song playing. Peter, in gravelly voice. New York, Queens. It's a rough borough. Hey, it's home. Happy, who you talking to? Peter, in normal voice. No one. Just making a little video of the trip. Happy, you know you can't show it to anyone. Peter, yeah, I know. Happy, then why are you narrating in that voice? Peter, because it's fun. Happy, fun. Peter, so, why do they call you Happy? Come on, I'm not carrying your bags. Let's go. Peter, hey, should I go to the bathroom before? Happy, there's a bathroom on it. Peter, whoa, no pilot. That's awesome. Peter, HH, is that where you're gonna sit? Yeah, this is your first time on a private plane. My first time on any plane. Should it be making that noise? SHH, snoring. Peter giggles quietly. No one has actually told me why I'm in Berlin or what I'm doing. Something about Captain America going crazy. This is you. Peter, oh, we're neighbors. They're not roommates. Suit up. Okay, Peter, you got this. Happy, what the hell are you wearing? It's my suit. Where's the case? What case? What? I thought that was a closet. This is still my room. Oh, my room is way bigger than there. Peter, I found the case. A minor upgrade. Oh, my God. Put it on. What the? This is the coolest thing I've ever seen. Let's go. But, yeah, well, don't understand. Is it for me? Happy, wait, this is insane. Look at this thing. Look at the eyes. This is the greatest day of my life. Okay, let's go. Peter, whispering. Okay, there's Captain America, Iron Man, Black Widow. Whoa, who's that new guy? Tony, on Deruz. Oh, that's me. I gotta go. Mechanical squeak and Peter grunts. Peter, in normal voice. Hey, everyone. Mechanical rumbling. The craziest thing just happened. I just had a fight with Captain America. I stole his shield. I threw it at him. What the hell? He's big now. I gotta go. Hang on. Mechanical whine. Peter yells. It was the most amazing thing. Mr. Stark was like, hey, on Deruz. I flipped in and stole Cap's shield. I was like, what's up, everybody? And knocking on door. Hey, just a second. Coming. Hey, we have thin walls here. What are you doing? A little video diary. Peter, yeah, it's alright. I'd do the same thing. Happy. Props. Previously on Survivor. The alliance of John, Tammy, General and Zoe maintain strategic control of the camp. They've all decided to vote the same. When I give you my word is huge. It's the most important thing to me. Nelly and Pascal, I think, are really supporting my success. In this game, 3 strikes and you're out. Props. But the alliance's blatant display of power at the immunity challenge caused Pascal and Nelly to rise up against them. They just didn't play it smart in that game. I'm not going to go out 5th or 6th. We've worked too hard. Props. At tribal council, they joined V, Sean, and Kathy, and voted John, the leader of the alliance, off the island. John, the tribe has spoken. Okie-doke. Props. 8 are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Very nice. Oh, God, it's so good. It's a new day. I think I can win. I feel so good this morning. I found myself before, kind of, having my destiny in other people's hands, and now it's a new spirit. It's a new day we're starting. Here, hello, world, you're going to be the first Jet Beauty of the Week. Now that myself, Kathy, V, Happy and Nelly got together, we said you know what, truly may the best man win, with no alliance, Marquesan Islands. It is beautiful. We want the people who play this game fairly, and don't try and manipulate people to have a good chance to get to the top. This is funny, I mean, to see that we had turned around, like that at the last second, and beat them at their own game. I just think it's hilarious, like I just laughed my head off. Oh, yeah, the taro that did it. Okay, all the lamps are fixed and full. All right, the mood is very, very happy. Among those 5 people, I mean, they're all very, they're happy. You know, they're sitting pretty. They've got 5 of them. We're going to have to go to bed at night. It's so important that we just maintain this. I got to tell you one thing, though. We need to have some fun today. I know, for real. I want to find some more cowrie shells. So when you guys are going, I'm going to be in search of cowrie shells. Okay, we're 2 outcasts. I feel like an outcast sitting over here. You can't make them come over and hang out with us. They see us as traitors, even though they've all done the same. Oh, yeah, I want to be so truthful. I just want to be truthful. We have been from day one. That's why I said, you know what, when it comes down to it, I want to be with people that are going to be honest with me. Basically, we got screwed because of John. It's our fault for trusting him. I think that myself, Rob, and Zoe all have targets on our back because of the alliance. And unless something changes in the next few days, because I'm...
Beavis? Butthead?
I'm shocked. Everything is so clean. The conversation pit looks as neat as a pin. Well, I don't know what you did, but you two are geniuses.
We did an extra special job.
Yeah, because you're special.
Well, guys, I'm glad you've taken our little lesson to heart.
Well, you've certainly earned this, boys.
What a dork. He ripped us off.
Yeah. Work sucks.
What a wonderful job those boys did.
Ah! My 8-tracks! I'm gonna kill those little jerks!
What's wrong with his mouth?
Yeah, his mouth's fine.
I stand before my maker like Moses on the hill. My genius to record baker, I whoa. The first of reciter, I saw eternal light. Best of all.
Yeah.
Drain the tub.
Yeah, and then scrub it with the final.
Yeah.
And then pour some grape ball on there.
That would be pretty cool.
I wish I had boobs like that.
Yeah. If I had boobs like that, I'd never leave the house.
I'd leave the house. I can go get a mirror. Look at my boobs.
afford these beautiful clothes and this fine jewelry, but I'm still the same penniless washballer that I was before I won the $37 million, I guarantee. I even kept my job on the sludge crawler.
Sludge is cool.
Yeah.
I got me a couple AKs, some sawed-offs, 25 9mm, and a couple of ground-to-airs. I got a fort up in the hills virtually impenetrable, and enough supplies to outlast a 30-year standoff.
Lottery. Just a buck and a hoop.
Cool. Money is cool.
Come on out.
What do you want there?
Come on, baby.
Hey, it's that guy.
Like,
yeah. That guy.
Yeah.
I thought he was dead. Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Oh, it's pretty cool. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, yeah. I need more lights, color lights and stuff in video. Is this Seattle? I heard that's pretty cool. No, wait, what is this? This is like Hollywood or Beverly Hills 90235.
I told him not to. He was filming. I'm gonna wipe the chip. Tony, okay, hey, you know what? You should make an alibi video for your aunt anyway. You ready? Peter, an alibi. Sure, okay, we rolling. Get in the frame. Hey, hey, how you doing? What are you This was the scene that really set the tone for their relationship. When we recorded it, we were in Atlanta, and we had the two of them together, and it was, I think Brian may have even actually been a little bit annoyed at Shay Mike a couple of times, and I think you can feel it in here, in a really wonderful way. Laughs and then the animators. This was like the one where we really, I think all of us saw the animation coming back, and we realized that this movie had something special, with, like, the naturalism in the performances, and the relationship dynamics. Rothman, we also recorded them together sitting in chairs set up like a car, so, Brian was in front, and Shay Mike was in back, and they had microphones set up, and they kinda could just perform the scene over and over again, as if they were in an imaginary car. Miller the art team had, they'd give like 50 foam party logo options, just like 17 rounds to get the actual right logo for foam party. Lord, good use of resources. Miller, it's important that we get that accurate and right, or just the level of bougie-ness. Rothman, it's a pretty good name for a trendy coffee shop. Persichetti, it is. Lord, if this doesn't work out, we're all going into business together. Persichetti will take over Brooklyn. Rothman, could it be like Magic Mike, where we just open up a foam party in Las Vegas and just, Lord, of course. Rothman, Dubai, it doesn't feel like I have a choice right now. You don't. Ramsey, uncomfortable moment. Miller, we're just watching the movie. Persichetti, I know, I got lost in it. Lord, I got sucked into the movie. Miller, one thing, this is where you can, we could talk for a second about the chromatic aberration, the color separation, that's happening in a lot of these shots, or depth of field, where things that are in focus are clear, but things in back aren't blurry. They have, like, a printing process, like a four-color printing process color separation, that indicates where you're supposed to look, so sometimes it looks like you're watching a 3D movie without the glasses on. Persichetti laughs, that was on purpose. Miller, yes, but once you get used to it, you feel the sense that, really, every frame is supposed to feel like it is a piece of printed art. Lord, here's the second of three, kind of, runners, of Miles in his element, or not. Persichetti, yeah, that was one meant to really, call back to the one where he was passing his old school, and just to sort of set the two apart in a really distinct way. Ramsey, and you can see the colors and the camera work, everything is really different than what he was experiencing on the streets of Brooklyn, so it's a, this poor kid is tossed into a whole different fish tank. Rothman, there's a, on the cover of Great Expectations, there's an image of Pip getting a, what's the old guy in Great Expectations, Lord McWitch, Rothman McWitch grabbing Pip's shoulder in a cemetery from Great Expectations. Miller foreshadowing, Rothman technically foreshadowing, Miller, oh, look down there, Dr. Olivia, interesting, Persichetti, Dr. Olivia, oh yes, laughs, Lord good hiding the ball, everybody, Miller and Smiley Kid, was in every frame smiling weird, Rothman because it's not a real person, I think we can say that our least favorite extra is Smiley, unless somebody disagrees, unless somebody, Ramsey, I think he's, Lord he's somebody's favorite, Persichetti, yeah, I think he comes around, you know, he's great, then he's bad, and then he's great again. Rothman, right. Miller, he's like the extra in a live-action movie, who worms his way to the front of every shot. Persichetti, and he almost looks into the camera. Rothman, I wish we had extras looking in camera. I would have really appreciated that. Persichetti, zero. This little scene came in late, early and late. Lord, early, and we cut it, then we put it back in. On a true or false quiz at random. Do you know what score they would get? 50%? That's right. The only way to get all the answers wrong is to know which answers are right. You're trying to quit, and I'm not gonna let you. Persichetti, that expression there was ripped off of President Barack Obama. Just so you know, in case you were wondering. All chuckling. Miller, I love it. Miller, there is a rice cooker in the back, because Miles' roommate, Jack, is Korean-American. Rothman, I don't think we're gonna win. The inventive meta. We should go. Come on. You said you don't want to swing. You should just swing me. Okay. We can take the subway. Okay. Screaming. Flash, no. Look out. That was so much worse. Okay. It's okay. Dash, Spider-Man, are you okay? Dash, MJ, yeah. Come on. Okay. I'm so sorry. MJ whimpering. MJ, okay. Spider-Man, I'm sorry. I just feel so dumb. I didn't realize you were miserable. No, it was really fun. Right. That's why they call it a fling. And we flung. It was fun. It could have been more fun. We'll hang out again. Like, when do you think? I should see what that is. No. Dash, happy, it's what I do. Peter, he's always coming and going. Dash, MJ, Peter. Dash, Peter, oh no. Dash, MJ, oh god. Dash, Peter, oh no. I don't know what to do. Dash, MJ, Peter. Oh, I didn't see anything. Peter, this isn't what it looks like. No. Hey, practice safe. Okay, you must be MJ. Yeah, nice to meet you. Dash, May, so nice to meet you. Wait, have you been crying? We broke up. Dash, man outside. Hey, Spider-Man, thank you. I didn't know you broke up. I thought you were were in love. Can we talk about this in the kitchen? Happy, I should probably leave. I thought you guys were such a handsome couple. It's really about boundaries. Dash intercom buzzing. Let me answer the door. Let's go in here. Is that the door? Is it true? Dash Happy, I was gonna go, but Dash MJ, not now. Hey, I didn't know you were so awkward about sex. Peter, this has nothing to do with sex. Dash intercom buzzing. Happy, if you wanna go over it again. I mean, what's that sound? Peter up. Dash woman outside. Hey, Spider-Man. Dash Peter, oh my god. I mean, I'm happy to rehash it if you want to. May you take care of your side. I'll take care of mine. Dash cell phones chiming. Dash May, what is up with this phone? Will you get off your phones for 5 minutes? Just wanna talk to you about your relationship. Okay. MJ Peter, helicopters whirring on TV. What? Dash May gasps. Dash May, is that? Dash Happy, is that here? Helicopters whirring. Horns honking. Dash Man 1, yo, Peter Parker. Dash Man 2, yo, Peter. Maybe it's not such a big deal. /8 Jameson Spider Menace. /8 Governments around the world launch investigations. /8 into the murderer known as Spider-Man, aka Peter Parker. /8 aka the web-headed war criminal, who, for years, has been terrorizing the decent citizens of New York. Well, now the city and the world see him for what he truly is. /8 New details from last week's devastating attack in London have emerged. For more, we go now to Joint Intelligence Headquarters. Border authorities, just a short while ago, confirmed that the deadly drones used in the London attack were designed by Stark Industries. Dash banging on door. Dash Man 2 federal agents. Open up. Federal agents, you stay here. Cleary Department of Damage Control, we have a warrant for the arrest of Peter Parker. You know the Fourth Amendment? Dash Cleary, sure. Unreasonable search and seizure. Get in here, guys. Let's go. Bellis greets in Japanese. English. Special Agent Lance Sterling. How you living? Hook shouting in Japanese. Oh, okay, okay. Everybody good. I'm just gonna take his gun, and I'm gonna toss it to that snowman. And while you're both looking all confused, trying to figure out what's going on, I'm just gonna knock you out. Hook groan. Pigeon coos. Scrim and splatters. Ugh, he didn't deserve that. Rats with wings. The speakers, I'm in. Seen as the leader after John, I'm the next to go. You, then me, kid. That's the pecking order. Yeah, that's alright. Thanks. We'll see. The game's not over yet. My allegiance is to Zoe and Rob at this point. Zoe fits right into that group now. I really don't know what game Zoe is playing. I wanted to see how strong our alliance was. I just told Zoe, I said, you know, I'm glad that, you know, we were on a team for a while. Well, it was a pretty loose friendship on my line. The alliance was, I mean, whatever game you want to play now is fine, but that's not what you were saying earlier. Zoe tried to say that she wasn't in alliance with John, Rob and myself. And you know what? That's just not true. If you want me to keep my mouth shut now so you can play your game, that's one thing. Be straight with me. I'd respect that much more than me right now. You want me to tell you from the get-go I didn't like you. I didn't really dig you. I didn't like dig the way your eyes were. Your presentation. I have changed my opinion of Zoe. Zoe is a bitch. I mean, she's just trying to save her own butt right now. Maybe her true colors will start to, you know, shine through and somebody will figure out who she is and want to vote her off instead of me. As far as the game goes now, I don't trust you. I don't trust you either. Cool. Then let's go gather some shells, because that's what I came here for. I didn't come here for a bunch of. I came here to get some shells. I'm distancing myself from Tammy at this point. I'm here to win. I'm here to be the final survivor. And if I had to say something to someone and do something exactly the opposite without them knowing or them finding out later, well, that's just the way it is. That's the way life is. A big coconut. We got mail. You guys are going to be so in love. Okay, you guys ready? Hard as a rock, sweet as can be, tough to get into as you soon will see. You're going to pair up, but you won't know with whom. Full bellies and a party if you both can pull through. Cheering, this is going to be good. Props. Okay, for today's reward challenge, you will compete as teams, or teams of two. You guys have already randomly drawn lots to determine who's paired with who. Sean and Pascal, Pammy and Vesapia, Kathy and the General, Nelly and Zoe. Your goal today, fill your 3-foot-tall bamboo shoe to the top with coconut juice. You can gather the coconuts in two ways. You can swim far out and get the large parcels of coconuts that are anchored in the water, or you can stay here on shore and pick up the coconuts that are scattered along the beach. First team to fill their chute wins. Now for the reward. The winning team will be picked up at your beach by helicopter. You'll be dropped off atop a mountain where two horses will be waiting for you. You will take a really fun ride down to an authentic full-on Marquesan feast. You'll come back fully sated and ready for your last 13 days. Makes sense. Take your spots. Wait for my go. Remember, you can get individual coconuts on the beach or those tethered out in the water. Survivors ready? Go. That away, Sean. 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 Sean and Pascal with a really healthy coconut. You guys need to pick it up. You guys are dry. What's up? Keep working hard, guys. Kathy and General, you guys need to pick it up. Come on, let's get going. Let's do it, man. Okay.
Wow, you think those chicks do it?
What do you think, Bum Wife? They're almost naked.
Yeah, yeah.
Shut up.
Oh, yeah.
Is that Uranus?
Yeah, yeah.
Uranus is cool.
Yeah. Thanks.
What?
On the record when the drum beats go like this.
That guy in the chair seems pretty cool.
Yeah. He's like a pretty good guy.
Hey, Beavis.
Anyway, Brad shows up, and he's soaking wet and covered with welts, and he knew Heather was going to be there. Oh, my God.
God.
Cool.
Mystery meat.
I think it's cheese.
Hey, buddy, I just cut the cheese. Cut the cheese.
Hey, Beavis, check it out. It's Gina. Let's go talk to her.
Yeah, let's go talk to her.
Needless to say, Todd was going ballistic, and by then he was up to his elbows in refried beans.
Ew.
What do you want?
What do we want?
Don't you guys have some brain cells to kill? Look, if I give you a dollar, will you get the hell away from me?
A dollar?
Cool.
A dollar.
Hey, Beavis. Gas. That's perfect. We even get change.
Gas. Yeah, yeah, that's cool.
This is gonna be cool.
1 gallon of gas, please.
Where's your car?
Car?
Motorcycle? Lawnmower?
Can't we just get it in a cup?
Yeah, or a bag or something. That would be cool.
No way, dude. Can't give you no gas without a container. Look, if you got a dollar burning a hole in your pocket, why not buy a lottery ticket?
Cool. Yeah.
This sucks. We lost. Let's get out of here.
Wait a second, guys. You didn't even scratch it. Man, you guys won $500.
Whoa. We're rich.
Yeah, yeah. Like Mr. Howell on Gilligan's Island.
Cool. Skulls.
Yeah. Skulls.
Position. What is your situation? Just getting a visual. Now, Oilus, 10 o'clock, Lance, Katsu Kimura, everybody's favorite arms dealer. Oilus, here, a briefcase is your objective. Inside is the M9 Assassin, the first semi-autonomous attack drone, powered by atmospheric energy. Never shuts down, never stops pursuing its target. They stole it from our covered weapons lab. Computer beeping, Director Jenkins, he's got incoming. Detecting 70 extra hostiles around the perimeter. Size, I don't want another mess like Kyrgyzstan. Lance, listen to me. You've got 70 Yakuza incoming. Stand down. Lance, scoffs, that's better odds than I usually get. No, not engage. This time, you need to wait for the backup team. Scoffs, team, fly solo. Lance, listen to static feedback, tears throat, I think he cut off, get it, yeah, wait, that's right, sorry, Doyless eyes, indistinct chatter, laughs, groans, thuds, indistinct shouting continues, exclaims, yelling, choking, speaking Japanese, Lance, indistinct chatter, Lance, no, this is time to introduce myself, beeping, yells, beat music playing, screaming, you know how you can tell, when you're the world's greatest spot, groans frustratedly, Sterling, Lance Sterling, everyone knows the name, I'm a need that case, speaking Japanese, grunts, yelling, groans, chuckles, just 3 ounces of pressure to the vagus nerve, and then look at your boy, sleepy night night, chuckles, hey, you mind giving me a hand, stop, on him, I don't get it, pause it, yeah, go back, why don't you get it, just don't get it, he's blonde and he's cute, oh, his eyebrows are just like, shut up, his eyebrows, that's the one thing you couldn't get, yeah, oh, my god, you see what he does, oh, how does he even do that, that's the whole point why I'm showing you, genius, so bad, hey, pardon me, sir, I think you have the wrong car, we woke up in here, what the hell is going on, what are we doing here, what happened to my dad, he's out there, do you know what happened to my dad, I choose you first, it's only gonna be a minute, pee on yourself, no, open the door, hey, are you okay, he wanted me to dance for him, the outside door is locked, everything's okay, we're okay, I hear the tiniest little splash, and here it comes, a freak of nature, like this, so, he comes across the stream, and he's so tall, that the water doesn't even get to his belly. Then he stops, and my heart's coming out of my chest. You got buck fever. Uncle John's got buck fever. That's not true, Casey. Your daddy's a liar. How big was the rack? It was huge. Where are you supposed to look when you shoot, Casey? At the body. Then why was he looking at the rack? Cause he had buck fever. You'll say anything you say. You're gonna do that with the board were killed. Lord Vader, the battle station plans are not aboard this ship, and no transmissions were made. An escape pod was jettisoned during the fighting, but no life forms were aboard. She must have hidden the plans in the escape pod. Send a detachment down to retrieve them. See to it personally, Commander. There'll be no one to stop us this time. Yes, sir. How did we get into this mess? I really don't know how. We seem to be made to suffer. It's our lot in life. Lip whistle. I've got to rest before I fall apart. My joints are almost frozen. What a desolate place this is. Leap blip. Where do you think you're going? Well, I'm not going that way. It's much too rocky. This way is much easier. What makes you think there are settlements over there? Beep blip. Don't get technical with me. Beep beep. What mission? What are you talking about? Whistle beep beep. I've just about had enough of you. Go that way. You'll be malfunctioning within a day. You nearsighted scrap pile. And don't let me catch you following me, begging for help, because you won't get it. Beep whistle. No more adventures. I'm not going that way. That malfunctioning little twerp. This is all his fault. He tricked me into going this way, but he'll do no better. Wait, what's that? A transport. I'm saved. Over here. Hey, hey. Help. Please help. Whistle whistle. Beep blip blip beep. Speaking alien language. Dash. Yells. Dash. RDD2 screams. Speaking alien language. Speaking alien language. Beep whistle blip. Whistle blip blip. R2. Blip blip. R2D2. It is you. It is you. Whistle whistle. Grunting. Someone was in the pod. The tracks go off in this direction. Look, sir. Droids. We stopped. Wake up. Wake up. Beep blip beep beep. We're doomed. Speaking alien language. Do you think they'll melt us down? Beep blip. Don't shoot. Don't shoot. Will this never end? Speaking alien language. On. Let's go. BERU. Luke. 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 Tell your uncle if he gets a translator. Be sure it speaks Bocce. Doesn't look like we have much choice, but I'll remind him. Dash. Speaking alien language. Yeah. We'll take that red one. No. Not not that one. You, I suppose you're programmed for etiquette and protocol, why, it might be disruptive for you, but perhaps someone you're familiar with, an old friend, like Master Kenobi. That's possible. He's just returned from a border dispute on Anshin. Do it for me, m'lady. Please, the thought of losing you is unbearable. I will have Obi-Wan report to you immediately, m'lady. Senator Amidala, thank you, Master Windu. You seem a little on edge. Not at all. I haven't felt you this tense since we fell into that nest of Gundarks. Scoffs, you fell into that nightmare, Master, and I rescued you, remember? Oh, yes, laughing, chuckles, you're sweating, relax, take a deep breath. I haven't seen her in 10 years, Master. Obi, Mesa, so smiling to see Anyusa. Good to see you again, Jar Jar. Senator Padme, Mesa Palos here. Looky, Senator, this is Jedi Arriban. It's a great pleasure to see you again, m'lady. It has been far too long, Master Kenobi. Ani, my goodness, you've grown. So have you. Grown more beautiful, I mean. Well, F for a senator, I mean. Ani, you'll always be that little boy I knew on Tatooine. Our presence here will be invisible, m'lady, I can assure you. I'm Captain Typho of Her Majesty's Security Service. Queen Jamilia has been informed of your assignment. I am grateful you are here, Master Kenobi. The situation is more dangerous than the senator will admit. I don't need more security. I need answers. I want to know who's trying to kill me. We are here to protect you, Senator, not to start an investigation. We will find out who's trying to kill you, Padme. I promise you, we will not exceed our mandate. My young Padawan learner, I meant that in the interest of protecting her, Master. We will not go through this exercise again. Whistle beep. Speaking Huttus. Whistle beep whistle. Speaking Huttus. C-3POA. I tota mishka jabba do hut. Kutawanki mit bikosa. Ha ha ha. I don't think they're going to let us in, R2. We better go. Rumble. Creak. Whistle. Beep whistle beep. R2. Wait. Whistle. Oh dear. R2. I really don't think we should rush into all this. Beep beep. Oh. R2. Wait for me. Whistle beep. Gur. Beep beep. Gur. Just you deliver Master Luke's message and get us out of here. Oh my. Oh no. Speaking Huttus. Day one Awanga. Oh my. D1 Awigo. Beep. We bring a message to your Master Jabba the Hutt. Day Jabba Wanga. Beep beep. And a gift. Give. What gift? Beep whistle. Any Jabba no Barta. He's Iokta. Whistle whistle. Is he Kata Omokti? Beep beep. Any Charta so Didi. Whistle beep. He says that our instructions are to give it only to Jabba himself. Whistle whistle. Gur. I'm terribly sorry. I'm afraid he's ever so stubborn about these sort of things. Nutshot. R2. I have a bad feeling about this. Whistle. Whoa. ARF. Have a notice, my lord. Good morning, R2. Buzz droid squawks. Watch out. Whistles. R2. Hit the buzz droid center. Beeping. Yeah, you got him. Great, R2. The general's command ship is dead ahead. R2-D2 squealing. Well, have you noticed the shields are still up? Sorry, master. Oh, I have a bad feeling about this. There they are. Hit them. Beeping. Whistling. This is a healthy one, too. Okay, let's do that one. You might want to try to chop that other one. Probst, you're in this game. Guys, keep it up. You got it, Zoe. Look at that. You're in the game. With one coconut. Oh, Zoe, we are on top of it. Probst, keep fighting. Guys, Sean got a system. Sean and Pascal have a bit of a lead over Nelly and Zoe. Go get us some more coconuts. I got this. Check them every once in a while. Probst, Tammy and V, falling behind. You guys got a whole lot of coconuts and no juice. Kathy and the general right back in it. This is it. We got the system. We're doing well. Probst, Zoe and Nelly, gaining fast. Now you're going, Sean. That away. Vesapia. One coconut can get you right back in it. Keep going. Probst, we got a game right now. Sean and Pascal getting closer. Guys, don't let up. Get me some more. Pap, more. Come on. I don't care if it's hard. We've got to keep going. Probst, Sean and Pascal very close. Happy. We're not out of this yet, baby. Probst, we're in a dead heat right now. We're going to win it. This is your win. Probst, this could be it. Sean and Pascal. Nice work. Sean and Pascal. Nice work. Well earned. Is this the most unlikely pair? Huh? The old man and the brother. The old man and the brother. Probst, hold it out. By the grace of God, man. Probst, I guarantee you, tomorrow is going to be a great day for you guys. You guys can head back to camp. I'll see you tomorrow. I'm ready. I'm ready for my mission. I want a full description of it as soon as you get back. Look at those clouds, you guys. That's pretty cool. Look at the pink in the clouds. I never thought I'd be sitting here on day 26. Do I look okay? You look beautiful. Oh my god, remember, you have to have lots of alcohol and lots of pig. That's right. I've got to eat slow because of my stomach. Yeah, go real slow and get really silly and have so much fun. I'm so happy for you too. Sean and Pascal won a helicopter ride and awaiting them will be a Marquesan feast, and I'm happy for them. Sean deserved it. After all of the mess that some of these people in the Rotuk tribe put him through, he was down, but he was never out. See you when we get back. I'm about to start crying with these guys. I'm so happy for them. Oh my god, I feel like they're going away. They're only going to be gone a couple hours. I know, but it's exciting. It's so exciting, isn't it? Pat, look how beautiful that is. We're going to see this thing all the way through, buddy. Yes, sir, man. This is getting ready to be awesome. I'm going to tell you, man, I love you, Pappy. You too, my man. Now this is what I call a reward right here. Unbelievable. Look at us. Hello. This is crazy. Look what we have coming here. Pappy and I are standing there, like, okay. All of a sudden these Marquesan men come down the hill with these horses. My name, Akatini. Pascal, Academy, Akatini, Akatini. Sean, I got to get the wild one. Your horse, he's okay. Okay. The only horses I've been on are merry-go-rounds in Central Park. Where does my other foot go? Okay. And it was a bit scary, because...
This video looks pretty cool, but it's like, the sound sucks.
Yeah. Check it out, bud.
Whoa. That's better.
And I'm a dead guy in the corner, and I'm like a zombie.
That was pretty good, Beavis. You should, like, be a lead singer.
Yeah, I'm getting clown makeup.
I think, like, if we did that over this video, it would be, like, a buzz clip.
Yeah. What a cool...
Check this out.
1 gallon of gas, please.
Yeah, check it out. We got a container.
What is this?
Yeah, what is this?
Ugly kid chose.
How can he call himself ugly kid? It's like he's not even that ugly.
Do you find him attractive, Beavis?
No, wait for it. Shut up.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
This guy seems pretty cool.
Yeah. He's pretty cool for an old guy.
Yeah.
Go for it.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Sometimes old people are cool.
Yeah.
Mistress, I just got off the phone with the warden at the state penitentiary. We're going to revive the Scared Straight program, and I need to pick out those students who are most likely to run into trouble with the law.
Do you want to see their files?
I don't need the files. Bring me the yearbook. That kid looks like a criminal. Hey, I know. Where are those two kids that flushed every roll of toilet paper in the entire school?
You mean Beavis and Butthead?
Yeah, that's them. Beavis and Butthead.
What is this?
Yeah, what is this? Yes,
Judas Priest.
Yes.
This is gonna be cool.
Yes.
How come Rob Halford is dressed up like that?
R2, locate the Chancellor. Chirps, groaning, whistles. Obi-Wan, the Chancellor's signal is coming from right there. The observation platform at the top of that spire. I sense Count Dooku. I sense a trap. Next move, spring the trap. Whistling. R2, go back. I need you to stay with the ship. Here, take this and wait for orders. Beeping, growls, coughing. What's the situation, Captain? Two Jedi have landed in the main hangar bay. We're tracking them, just as Count Dooku predicted. Coughs, cackles, clattering destroyers. Drop your weapons. I said drop them. Roger, 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 roger. All groaning. Beeps, those are Jedi fighters alright. Beep softly. Did you press the stop button? No, did you? No. Well, there's more than one way out of here. Obi-Wan, we don't want to get out. We want to get moving. R2, activate elevator 31174. Obi-Wan on comlink, come in. R2, what that? R2, do you copy? Electronic twittering. R2, activate the elevator number. Muffled 31174. Chirp softly. Get back to work. That nothing. Obi-Wan, muffled, activate the elevator 31174. R2, we, side I'm on. Aha, you're imagining things, am I? Then why are you following me? Afraid I was gonna leave without giving you a goodbye kiss? I'd just as soon kiss a Wookiee. I can arrange that. You could use a good kiss. I didn't ask you to turn on the thermal heater. I merely commented that it was freezing in the princess's chamber. How will we dry out her clothes? Beep beep. Oh, switch off. Why did you take this apart now? I'm trying to get us out of here, and you pull both. Excuse me, sir. Put them back together now. Might I have a word with you, please? What do you want? Well, it's Princess Leia, sir. She's been trying to get you on the communicator. I turned it off. I don't want to talk to her. Well, Princess Leia is wondering about Master Luke. He hasn't come back yet. She doesn't know where he is. I don't know where he is. Nobody knows where he is. What do you mean? Nobody knows. Well, you see, deck officer. Deck officer. Excuse me, sir. Yes, sir. Do you know where Commander Skywalker is? I haven't seen him. It's possible he came through the south entrance. It's possible. Why don't you go find out? It's getting dark out there. Yes, sir. Excuse me, sir. Might I inquire what's going on? Why not? Impossible, man. Come along, R2. Let's find Princess Leia. Between ourselves, I think Master Luke is in considerable danger. Ring. Sir, Commander Skywalker hasn't come in the south entrance. He might have forgotten to check in. Not likely. Are the speeders ready? Not yet. We're having trouble adapting them to the cold. We'll have to go out on tauntauns. Sir, the temperature's dropping too rapidly. That's right, and my friend's out in it. Maul. Blasters cocking. Villagers exclaiming. Phasma, on my command. Fire. Villagers screaming. Poe, please, no. Indistinct stormtrooper radio chatter. Bolt crackling. FN-2187 gasps. Stormtrooper, nothing here. Go ahead. BB-8 chirps. BB-8 moans softly. Creature exclaims in alien dialect. Alright, alright. Indistinct PA chatter. FN-2187 panting. Gasping. Phasma. FN-2187. Submit your blaster for inspection. Yes, Captain. And who gave you permission to remove that helmet? I'm sorry, Captain. Report to my division at once. Panting. Speeder revving. Resize. Staff clacks. Scavenger 1 exclaims. Jittering in alien dialect. Scavenger 2 laughing. On car. What you brought me today is worth. One quarter portion. Speeder racing. Sizzling. Faint booming. BB-8 chirping faintly. BB-8 chirping nervously. Tito speaking alien dialect. Tito exclaiming. BB-8 chirping. Tito shouting in alien dialect. Speaking alien dialect. Tito and BB-8 exclaiming. Speaking alien dialect. Ray shouting in alien dialect. Tito chittering. BB-8 EBH chirping. Tito and Ray arguing in alien dialect. Tito scoffs. EBH chirps angrily. SHH, that's just Tito. Wants you for parts. He has no respect for anyone. BB-8 exclaims softly. Your antenna's bent. Where do you come from? BB-8 chirping excitedly. Classified, really? Chirps merrily. Me too. Big secret. Naima outpost is that way. Stay off Calvin Ridge. Keep away from the sinking fields in the north. You'll drown in the sand. BB-8 chirping happily. Don't follow me. Town is that way. BB-8 sighs. BB-8 chirps inquisitively. No. BB-8 moans dejectedly. BB-8 chirping merrily. In the morning, you go. BB-8 chirps happily. You're welcome. KYLO Ren. I had no idea we had the best pilot in the resistance on board. Comfortable? Not really. I'm impressed. No one has been able to get out of you. What you did, ship? That puny ship is too small and at too close range. We need to scramble our fighters. 5 bloody minutes ago. He'll never penetrate our armor. He's not trying to penetrate our armor. He's clearing out our surface cannons. 1 cannon left, and here comes the parade. BB-8 chirping nervously. Yeah, I see him. Dash, machinery sparking. No. Damn it, BB-8, my weapon systems are down. We gotta take out that last cannon, or our bombers are toast. Work your magic, buddy. BB-8 chirping. BB-8 chirping nervously. BB-8 moans. Are the auto cannons primed? Primed and ready, sir. What are we waiting for? Fire on the base. Punch it. The last transport is in the air. The evacuation is complete. You did it, Poe. Now get your squad back here so we can get out of this place. No, General Poe, we can do this. We have the chance to take out a dreadnought, Poe. These things are fleet killers. We can't let it get away. Disengage now, Leia. Commander, that is an ore. Wipe that nervous expression off your face, Rivia. Oh, well, I will certainly try. General, nervous. Let's go, BB-8. It's now or never. BB-8 chirping. BB-8 shrieking. Poe, yes. BB-8 exclaims softly. All clear. Bring the bombs. Captain, resistance bombers approaching. Of course they are. Bombers, keep that tight formation. Fighters, protect the bombers. It's not every day we get a shot at a dreadnought, so let's make this count. Copy that, Blue Leader. Bomber 1, you get us there. We'll give it to them. Pilot 1, copy. We're on it. Fighters incoming. Gunners, look alive. Pilot 2, snuff fighters at 210. Pilot 3, they're coming in. Pilot 2, warm up. They're everywhere. Yells. Pilot 4, here they come. Pilot 5, incoming fighters. Warm up. Pilot 6, vector in at attack speed. Pilot 5, won't be enough, sir. I want Droid Akas up here at once. We will not survive this. Whining. Close the blast doors. That will hold them. They are still coming through. This is impossible. Where are those Droid Akas? Master, destroyers. They have shield generators. It's a standoff. Let's go. They're no match for Droid Akas. Sir, they've gone up the ventilation shaft. Battle droids. It's an invasion army. This is an odd play for the Trade Federation. We've got to warn the Navo and contact Chancellor Valorum. Let's split up. Go aboard separate ships and meet down on the planet. You were right about one thing, Master. The negotiations were short, sir. A transmission from the planet. It's Queen Amidala herself. At last we are getting results. Again you come before us, Your Highness. You will not be so pleased when you hear what I have to say. Viceroy, your trade boycott of our planet has ended. I was not aware of such failure. I have word that the Chancellor's ambassadors are with you now, and that you have been commanded to reach settlement. I know nothing of any ambassadors. You must be mistaken. Beware, Viceroy. The Federation has gone too far this time. We would never do anything without the approval of the Senate. You assume too much. We will see. She's right. The Senate will never. It's too late now. Do you think she suspects an attack? I don't know, but we must move quickly to disrupt all communications down there. As it was huge. I mean, horses are big animals. I hope these horses are alright. If they decide they want to throw you off, you're on the ground with broken bones. Nice horsey. How you doing? Oh, he's biting him. Oh my god. I want off. Okay, come on here. On this horse, with me. And the last thing you want to see is two horses, or the horses like biting each other and just. Oh, see. But the Marquesan men seem to have them under control. I'm like, no, this is not going to work. It really hurts. Wait, my balls. It really hurts. Oh my god. You got to remember, we're not on flat land. We're on like a mountain cliff. So if you fall off, you're falling off the damn mountain with a horse under you. This is the kind of stuff that scares me. It was a long ride for some of us not used to horses, but Sean began to loosen up and began singing, and after they made some different arrangements, I'm chilling on a horse with Marquesan men. Everybody knows that we want to do it again. I said, oh, I hear the drums. We're getting close. What? Yeah, Marquesan forever. Yahweh, Yahenwi. This is better than Gilligan's Island. All right, what you doing afterwards? My name is Layla, hi, I'm Sean. You're very pretty. A little too young for me, though. We get to the beach and these two beautiful, although young, Marquesan women lead us to these two beach chairs with these huge pillows with these two huge coconut drinks. Here's to you, Pap. You too, baby. Success and happiness, man. I wish our team could see this. Well, who knew that a little black boy from Harlem would be here with a judge, a southern white judge from Georgia. I dig the fate in that, the irony in that. 2 days ago, I would have mortgaged my house on the fact that Sean was going to be voted off, but things have dramatically changed. Sean, while he may have some problems, he's honest. He's straightforward. That's all I can ask. Sometimes relationships start out rocky, and to look and see where we ended up, man, the sky is the limit for all of us. We became much closer than we were, and I feel very close to him. I feel very fortunate to know him. That's what's good about this game. You never know what's going to happen. I'm ready to eat, man. Are you? It just can't get any better than this. Follow. Speaking foreign language, orc. After we finished our drinks, they took us to the Marquesan oven. There's a ceremony where they bury food for a certain amount of days. That's how they cook their food, underground, with the heat and the volcanic rocks. There was a roasted pig under there with plantains and potatoes and roasted goat. Oh man, look at the meat, Pap. Can you believe this? The Marquesan people, when they were going through their tribal ritual, I don't know how to put it in words. For me to be here on this island in the South Pacific, with all the history it has, you just have to sit down and comprehend and savor the moment, because this is not going to happen again probably in my lifetime. Speaking in foreign language, and then both over here. Oh man. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this food which we are about to receive, and Lord, we thank you for the Marquesan people and their beautiful, rich culture. I thank you for bringing Pappy into my life, and I pray this is a lifelong friendship, Lord, through your son, Jesus Christ.
Oh,
You know, it's like, I still like Judas Priest and everything, but this really sucks.
Yeah, it's like all this stuff too fucks.
Yeah. Boy, this really sucks.
Yeah, yeah. I don't understand this. It's too fucks.
Yeah.
Use a lot of filthy language. That's the only way to get kids' attention these days. Hey, do that thing with your eye and your leg, and there may be a conjugal visit in it for you.
All right, listen up, you little... You stinking... have the freedom I'd kill for, but you little look like the type that'll... it up.